heads. Bryant, you're the visiting team. Tails, heads. What's going to be your call?
Tails.
Tails is the call. Aiden Hill from the Stanley Cup, Vegas Golden Knights, is going to flip the coin and do the honors. Tails is the call. And what, you won the honor. Bryant has won the toss, and they will defer to the second half. UNLV will receive.
UNLV has not been a great defensive program. I think that's about the team.
And on the offensive side, it all starts and ends with Doug Brumfield running this new go-go offense. Brumfield, the starter from opening day, which is going to be huge for the confidence for number two.
Yeah, Doug's got to stay healthy. That's the biggest thing. Last year got in 8 starts, also had 2 games where he started and went out. And he's got a plethora of weapons, young guys in terms of true freshmen, little guys, a lot of speed. Brendan Marion said, I brought in all the speed. We're going to go-go, and we're going to get down the field.
Should be a really exciting game as they welcome in the Bryant Bulldogs, who went 4-7 in the Big South last year. And the Rebels get an opening day win, the first time under Barry Odom. Their first opening day win under a new coach since John Robinson took over the program in 1999. And it's a really interesting stylistic matchup today. Two offenses that like to run a gun up and down the field.
Absolutely. Zebby Ackhouse is a high-level quarterback, a guy that landed at Bryant because of the COVID year. He's a Culver City, California dude. And Chris Merritt told me in a discussion during the week, he's like, you know, we just stayed on him. And programs like Bryant and UNLV can take advantage of the fact, Matt, that roster building is different than it was, say, 5 years ago with the transfer portal. A lot of the big programs want to be old and stay old, so they don't offer as many freshmen as they used to. And Bryant landed Zebby Ackhouse, and he's a hell of a player.
UNLV will receive the opening kickoff, heading from left to right on opening day here at Allegiant Stadium. And you see Barry Odom getting set for his first game at the helm of the Rebel program. Back to receive the kickoff is Jet Thomas. And along with him, it'll be Donovan Lester. Lester will take it down the far sideline. He gets some space. He's brought down around the 30-yard line. That's where UNLV will take over. Well, Steve, a lot of talk about both of these sides. What are your keys to the game?
Keys to the game today. And we start off with the Rebel defense has got to set the edges against Zebby Ackhouse because he's a guy who can get outside the tackle. The O-line, this is a somewhat veteran O-line, although they have 3 new starters, a lot of guys in the rotation
last year. So the O-line has to come together, and key number 3 for the Rebels today, take care of the ball. UNLV running backs, there's going to be 2 backs in this backfield in the go-go. A lot of misdirection. Take care of the ball.
The give right off the bat is to Vincent Davis. He's got some space across the 30. Davis tackled. No, he's up and dangling towards the end zone. A first play touchdown for the Rebels. How about the start for UNLV?
Well, that is an exclamation point. And I'll tell you, if you looked on the depth chart that came out on Monday, in the ones and twos, no Vincent Davis. I'm watching before the game. I see Vincent Davis walking up the tunnel during one of the breaks in the pregame. He's got a pretty good limp. Didn't look like it there.
No,
he
sir.
He turned on the Jets, and this is a guy they had high expectations from, transferring in from Pittsburgh. Brendan Marion worked with him back then. He said, this is a guy who's high energy, brings the juice to the team, and my Lord, he did it there.
A little bit of juice. 61 yards on the first play from scrimmage for Vincent Davis as Jose Paisano, the new place kicker, replacing Daniel Gutierrez, punches it home. One play and a 7-0 lead. The go-go offense is quick. I don't know if we thought it was that quick.
Well, you know, the misdirection can be confusing, but I mean, he had a gaping hole and then even down the field, he got popped a little bit, ran through any sort of tackler. And, you know, the other thing is Jet Thomas took the kickoff back, which I think the return game is going to be much better than it's been the last couple of years. They have high expectations for Jet Thomas. The name is appropriate. He's a burner. And that was special. That's a hell of a way to start off the go-go offense. Tuck Brumfield's job is going to be really easy if you can just hand it off and guys are ripping off chunk plays.
And what's interesting is that a lot of the talk about the go-go offense is on Brumfield. It's on the quarterback and the wide receivers. But Brendan Marion, the new offensive coordinator, told us that they expect to run the ball a lot and with, you know, killer efficiency. They're going to see a lot of ground game today for the Rebels.
And they're deep. You know, they're deep at running back. Like I mentioned, Jet Thomas has made a real impression for the Rebels. There's really high expectations with Donovan Lester. And the funny thing is, Donovan Lester is the biggest one. He's supposed to be the fastest in a straight line. Vincent Davis didn't look like he had any trouble busting down the field.
Special teams already playing a big part in this game as the Fresno State transfer Andre Mayono kicks it off the other way and bringing it back in the end zone.
Cutting to the near side, brought down at the 15-yard line. It's going to be Anthony Frederick, the All-American kickoff return specialist a year ago. And that's where Bryant will take over, led by their fourth-year head coach, Chris Merritt. Well, now that we got a little bit on the offense for the Rebels, how about this 3-3-5 defense, Steve, led by Mike Shear?
They're going to see a lot of pressure, a lot of disguising where the pressure is coming from. So Zevi Eckhouse is going to really be mind blown to try to read what's coming at him from different sides of the field. Like I said, San Diego State has played this defense forever. Rocky Long is one of the masters of the defense. He was at New Mexico for a long time, so a lot of deception.
Zevi Eckhouse, one of the top quarterbacks in the history of this Bryant program, preseason all-conference, second team All-Big South last year. Passing on the first play, it's complete at the 20, wrestled down by a pair of UNLV Rebels, including Elijah Shelton. Slams the ball carrier to the turf, and that's kind of what we're going to see from this team. That was Frederick on the catch.
Yeah, Shelton's one of the bigger
defensive ends because Xavier Carter weighs in at about 215. Shelton's a very solid 230, 235. And then you got Fisher Kamak, who's an absolute giant. So Shelton's a good veteran player, a holdover from the last year, and a guy who came in from Utah State.
Both of these teams running an up-tempo offense. That counts to take the snap on second and two.
Bryant, an FBS team for the third consecutive season. And that one's complete to the outside. With the grab and then some is Jalen Powell, the Utah Tech transfer, originally from Los Angeles. And the first down of the game comes here with just under 14 to play in quarter number one.
Jackson Turner a little high on the tackle attempt. Of course, Jackson expected to be one of the real difference makers in terms of transfers in from Arizona to this Rebel defense.
Simi Bakar split back in the backfield for Bryant. Expecting to see a 4-to-5-man running back rotation for this Bulldogs team. Playing in the Big South last year, the Big South and the Ohio Valley Conference combining for a 10-team alliance this year. That counts gives to Bakar up the middle. He's stuffed right away. Able to wrestle for about 2 yards, but there's that gang-tackling mentality of the Mike Shear defense. It was Shelton, the initial tackler.
Yeah, all of the chaos at FBS level with the conferences. Well, teams are moving up, so that
actually affects some FCS conferences. So I think in the case of the Big South, they were actually in jeopardy of losing their auto bid to that playoff, so they combined with the OVC.
So Bryant will play 3 Big South teams and 3 Ohio Valley teams this season. Rolling to the near side is Eckhouse.
He's going to cut it up underneath. Able to get it near the 40, brought down it. We'll call it the 37. Third down upcoming. It was Tad Martinson and Jackson Woodard combining on the tackle. Woodard, the Arkansas transfer, brought over with Barry Odom and named a captain in his first year in Las Vegas.
Yeah, we'll keep an eye on Woodard, a little banged up. Looked like he was grabbing, I think, his right arm. He's actually going to come off the field. So Marcel McDuffie, one of the starting linebackers. I think we have Fred Tompkins on the field at that Woodard linebacker position.
Press coverage for UNLV on third down and 5 yards to go. Eckhouse looking for a man. Checks it down underneath. It's caught. And near the line to gain is Landon Ruggieri, the former walk-on. Thomas Anderson to bring him down. And decision time for Chris Merritt and Brian here early on.
You go for it?
I would. And it looks like Chris Merritt agrees.
Yeah, on his own 40 and a half. It is the analytics with a high percentage play. You can have your own 41.
They're going to bring the heavy package in, a tight end on each side. Now look to the sideline for a play as UNLV stacks the box.
Fourth down and one. Time on the play clock as it snapped. Bakar, then at the line of scrimmage. Did he get enough? It does not appear so. And the Rebels stuff the Bryant Bulldogs on their first defensive possession. It was Tat Martinson to bring him down.
That was a hell of a tackle. That was almost appear to be a tackle with one arm. Tat's one of these guys who's a great success story. You know, when the coaches, you know, the coaching staff changed over, some of the guys who didn't get a lot of playing time the last couple of years, Matt, then they have a new lease on life. And Martinson has absolutely taken advantage of it, and he makes a massive play there.
Tat Martinson, the former walk-on after transferring from American River College, held him up. Looked like Turner and Baldwin both came up from the safety spot to eventually bring down Simi Bakar. So great field position for UNLV as Brumfield takes over with a couple more running backs in the backfield. It's Lester and Davis once again. A little disappointed here as this one goes for just 2 yards, not quite the
61-yard touchdown run on the first play from scrimmage, but now we get a chance to really get into this go-go offense in a short field.
Yeah, Kenny Dyson, the star defensive end for Bryant, kind of blew that play out by pushing Tiger Shanks into the backfield.
Jet Thomas, freshman running back,
split by himself, and they gave it to him. And at the 42, here comes a couple of Bulldog tacklers, and Jet, the freshman, brought down at the Bryant 36-yard line. It was Colin Elliott, the linebacker, to make the stop. Second down, make it third and five upcoming. UNLV bunches it in tight here. It's Thomas in the backfield once again. Brumfield looking to pass. He'll go far side. It's caught by Ricky White. Wrestling, reaching. He's got the first down. Great play. Check that. Seneca McKee on the catch. McKee, a senior from Columbia, South Carolina, gets the first down of the game for UNLV. Look at the effort there. Now it's Donovan Lester split by himself in the backfield. And we're really excited to get this guy from William and Mary, a four-year starter. He played under offensive coordinator Brendan Marion for a year. It's McKee
again on the near side. He's brought down immediately by Lake Ellis, the senior cornerback out of Orlando.
And McKee's a good story. Actually, the connect on McKee was former UNLV safety Tyson Player.
Here's Lester.
Up the middle. Stuffed after a gain of three. They're down in two upcoming. It was Yates to bring him down along with the nose tackle, Michael Lotti.
To build on that, you know, a lot of college recruiting now, getting guys from smaller levels, sometimes comes off the advice of your players. Like, hey, I used to play with this guy, or I know this guy. He's looking to transfer. We may want to take a chance on him. And, you know, McKee set a tone last year as a leader off the field. And this year, he's now stepped up to the one line at wide receiver.
The running back rotation continues as Courtney Reese is joined by Jet Thomas. Brumfield takes the snap. Gives it up the middle once more. Across the line to gain and inside the 20. Actually brought down by Jarvis Rayside. That's the first touch for Reese. And it gets the Rebels into the NV Energy red zone.
You see Courtney back and making waves and making progress. One of the smaller backs and had a really good game against Notre Dame. Filled in nicely last year for Aiden Robbins when he was hurt. Robbins now off to BYU.
Reese, the leading returning rusher from the 2022 roster. It's Jet Thomas cutting inside, spinning, and he scores. The Rebels in on their first two drives. And Jet Thomas with his first collegiate touchdown to give the Rebels a two-touchdown lead.
That was nice. There was a bunch of good moves on that run. He ran through some contact.
Look at him get around his man. And right through the arm tackle of Javis Rayside. So taking advantage of the good field position. Rebels really didn't try to do too much there. Just jammed it down the middle. Had success once more. Here's Paisano once more, the Missouri State transfer. Kicks it up, it's in, and the Rebels with a two-touchdown lead after two drives. The go-go offense looking sharp in the first game of the year.
Huh. Hey, John. It's Tuesday, and we're still selling lots of cars.
That's right, Steph. We know how to make everything super easy. From a customer's arrival, purchasing a new vehicle, or servicing an existing one.
John.
That's right, Steph. In fact, we sell the most cars every day of the week, even on a Tuesday.
Hey, Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals, IBEW Local 357, and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
UNLV football presented by Finley
Toyota. So far, so good on opening day as UNLV leads Bryant 14-0. Along with Steve Cofield, I'm Matt Neverett. And as the Rebels come out for defense the second time through, who's going to be a big contributor that maybe we haven't mentioned his name yet?
On defense, maybe Marcel McDuffie, who's a guy who I don't think a lot of people know about, but they're raving about. That was a holdover from the last coaching staff. He's going to be a contributor. And we should mention Thomas Anderson, who was a surprise entry into the number one slot at cornerback. So those are two guys who stepped up. I think we're going to talk about Tat Martinson a lot. Hell of a story. 6'1", 300 pounds. You mentioned former walk-on, was not really in the mix last year to play. And he blew away Ricky Logo, the defensive line coach, by one, being a powerhouse in the weight room. And then he told me like 3 weeks ago, he's like, hey, he took what he did in the weight room and that strength onto the field.
Here's Anthony Frederick bringing it back for Bryant, the nation's leading returner in terms of yards last year, swallowed up at the 18. And
Fred Tompkins able to bring him down. That's where Bryant takes over for their second drive. This Bryant offense, similar to what we're expecting from this go-go in a lot of ways. A lot of plays, a lot of up-tempo, and a lot of it in the hands of Anthony Frederick.
We're going to talk about rule changes and the clock not stopping as much as it did in the past. It's not going to matter much with these two teams because they are going fast.
They're going to air it out. So it's Eckhouse and Bryant going from right to left. First time in the game for Fabrice McKendy, junior running back out of Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. He's got the ball now, finding some space, gets it across the 20. But he's tackled almost immediately. That is Marcel McDuffie. Just brought him up in the sophomore out of Grand Prairie, Texas. Able to bring him down. Second down upcoming.
To Anderson and Jonathan Baldwin in on the tackle as well. And, you know, Barry Odom likes his defense. He likes his personnel. He's got a good leader on each level of the defense. And Baldwin is absolutely one of those guys on the back end of the game.
Barry Odom, a defensive-minded coach. Spent many years at Missouri from 2003 to 2019. Many of those coaching on the defensive side of the ball. Eckhouse airs it out. It's incomplete. He was able to bring it down. Looked like from up here that he was
on the turf, and Landon Ruggieri, former walk-on, able to stick it with those gloves.
Lost a grip on it and then kind of pinned it against his legs.
Yeah. Oh man, from our vantage point, looked like he dropped it somehow. Able to corral that thing in using the shins.
Trickeration going between the legs.
I'd say that was intentional.
All right. So a first down for Bryant. Double defense. Holding strong, barring that circus catch. Nowhere to go in the backfield. Jonathan Baldwin comes up from his safety spot along with Jackson Woodard back in the game to combine for the tackle.
And you'll notice on the defensive line, Matt, they're already doing some rotation. Whitmore in there, transfer in from Austin Peay. Cooper Webb is another guy who's in and on the two line at defensive tackle. He's a guy that Ricky Logo was very familiar with, coaching him at Louisiana Monroe. So they went out and got guys to go in that big fella rotation up front that they knew would fit this 3-3-5.
Darius Johnson, also a returner, in a nose tackle position. Eckhouse dropping. Whoa. He's going to run it. He slides and able to get to the 42, brought down by Woodard. He was the nearest man to him.
Yeah, Woodard had talked in the pregame or this week about, you know, potentially having to be a spy on Eckhouse, and he needed to be there. Yeah,
kind of caught on the left side of the defense.
So it's a third down as Bryant heads back out. Ryan Clark, the running back, out there. Rebels held strong on third down last time. See what they can do for an encore.
Stacked receivers on each side as Eckhouse on third down. Fires over the middle, past a defender, near the line to gain, and this one's going to be close.
Wow. I thought Jackson Woodard had it. He read it. How close is this to being an INT?
It was Matthew Prochaska with the catch, and they're going to say fourth and inches. Bryant going for it once more.
Here we go.
UNLV held strong on fourth down last time, but now Bryant, fourth and inches upcoming, calls a timeout. They're going to want to talk this one over.
The runner was short.
Going to get the measurement.
The previous play is under review.
So they're going to look at the spot. We'll see what the decision is. A fourth and one upcoming.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority. And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Hello, I am Nikki Fargus, president of the Las Vegas Aces. I am proud to support the mission of Nevada Donor Network by sharing the need to register to be an organ, eye, and tissue donor. Right now, over 30,000 African Americans are waiting to receive a life-saving organ. You can help provide hope to those waiting simply by registering to be a hero. Nevadans are giving, and together we can save lives. Join us at wearenevadans.org.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust, but you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Hey, Steph, you know we sold 30 cars on Monday?
On a Monday?
Yes, a Monday.
A Monday?
Yes, a Monday.
I thought we were low on stock.
We've literally got tons of cars coming in all week long. Our customers at Finley Toyota can have anything they want.
Even on a Monday?
Even on a Monday. On any day of the week, we'll do anything to sell you a car. Even on a Monday.
Head referee Ken Ray reviewing that last play. Bryant near the line to gain, and with the fourth down upcoming, that spot going to be major. Ken Ray communicating with the replay official Bill Stimmel. Here's the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
So the call stands. It'll be a fourth down in inches. UNLV held strong the last time. Bryant had a fourth down upcoming. See what they can do here.
Got to go for it, right? Be consistent. Chris Merritt, the head coach, went
for a fourth and short just a couple minutes ago. Didn't get it, backfired, touchdown the other way. But if this is the way you coach, you got to be consistent, right? You're playing the numbers, so you can't flip-flop on the numbers. If it's a higher percentage play to go for fourth and short, you do it. And again, the ball's about the same spot it was last time.
At the 42.5-yard line, so we'll see what they come up with here. Last time it was Pat Martinson and Darius Johnson who broke the middle of the line and got the job done.
Under center is Eckhouse. And in motion comes across to push him. The pile moving. It's going to depend on the spot here, Steve.
Yeah, I think the late push got him across. Yeah, it's a good spot. So it looks like they got it. So
that was the wide receiver, Javen Dames, coming in motion. Reminiscent of the Bush push. Reggie Bush action. Pushing the quarterback across.
I mean, if everyone could do that formation that the Eagles do.
Oh, yeah.
You know, basically like it's just an anvil coming at you. Everyone would do it, but it's not as easy as the Eagles make it look.
So a first down for Bryant. Bryant at about midfield. They'll take the snap from their own 49-yard line. Eckhouse with some pressure. Airs it up. Going near sideline. Oh, almost brought in.
Wow.
That would have been a circus catch and then
some for Jalen Powell. Jackson Turner, really good coverage, but a great throw and almost a great catch.
Jeray Williams applying the pressure as well. That's a role he's going to be in a lot this season.
Well, you know, when they built this defensive backfield.
3-3-5 with five on the back end. Sometimes you'll even see a 3-2-6. They wanted to do a lot of cross training. You're going to hear a lot about the term cross training. They wanted to make sure that everyone could play in different areas of coverage.
Eckhouse fakes the give, airs it to the near sideline once more. And a nice grab made by Anthony Frederick, the top receiver on this Bryant team. Cameron Oliver with the coverage.
Eckhouse has an arm. That was a long throw. On a line, very accurate. It wasn't wide open, so he had to get in the right spot.
Eckhouse, who last year threw for over 3,000 yards, also threw for over 300 times, or 300 yards, I should say, six times last year. No stranger to the big game, a career high of 450 yards in a win last year. Third all-time in Bryant history in terms of passing yards, fourth in passing scores. He gives here, gives to Bakari on the far side.
Bakari over to the hash marks across the 40, brought down after a gain of two. Second down and eight upcoming. All three linebackers in, Williams, McDuffie, and Woodard combining on the stop.
Be interesting the rest of the way to track how many times they try to run over the right side. I was going to mention
Jalen Dixon, who's one of the smaller but twitchy linemen for the Rebels at about 265, but now he switched to the other side, so we'll see if they try to target him there. I don't think it's a weakness of this defense, though.
A lot of movement all over, as you mentioned, the cross training. We'll also see Xavier Carter at some point, linebacker and defensive end. Pass complete underneath, swarmed by a pair of Rebels as the running back Sidney Bakar Woodard in on it once again, with Thomas Anderson joining in on the tackle. So another third down upcoming. The Rebels trying to prevent Bryant from gaining five here. One thing we've noticed so far, Steve, is that the Rebels have not given any space around the outside. They're going press coverage all the way. 5 minute the line of scrimmage as well on third down and five. Now Woodard packs away. Zach House looks for a man. Goes underneath, gets tipped, and almost
intercepted. Good job of getting there, but Jare Williams not able to squeeze it on a ball tipped by Anthony Frederick.
Right in the face mask. And I'm glad you mentioned the press coverage, because this is a defensive unit that now has veteran guys at the corner, and Cam Oliver wasn't always
real comfortable playing up real close, and he's gotten closer and closer to the line over the years.
Throw, as we see on the replay, behind the wide receiver. Very nearly intercepted. Eckhouse lucky that it wasn't. Here comes the All-American kicker and team captain, Ethan Getman. 50 yards on the attempt here. The lefty has it up. It's short. It's way left, and it's no good. He missed one kick last year. That one no good from 50. And the Rebels defense holds strong. They've got a two-touchdown lead. Time winding down here in the first quarter.
Make this the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
Drought, drop by drop, harnessing the sun at the atomic level, partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce, improving public health, combating poverty, uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, Rebels make it happen.
Here's the first customer that bought a car.
The Avendros, that's the first date.
First one out.
No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota's led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We made the best memories and lasting friendships from the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
Rebels with the ball once more. Two-score lead against the Bryant Bulldogs in the opening game. As the last drive ended in a missed field goal by Bryant. All-American kicker Ethan Gettman nowhere close. UNLV and Doug Brumfield take over at their own 35-yard line on top by a 14-0 score. So far, so good, especially in the run game. This give is underneath. Cutting it up on the far sideline with some space. Now underneath. Contact at the 40 as he's brought down. That was Jacob DeJesus underneath. They love what they saw out of this kid in camp.
Now look at how fast they're going. You got the defense gassed, and next play's off here in less than 5 seconds.
You got two running backs put to Brumfield's right. He fakes it, and it's complete on the near side. But you know it, DeJesus again.
Back to the line of scrimmage. Here comes this go-go offense for UNLV. From the 30, second down and four. Reese and Thomas, the two running backs. Brumfield, who spoke during camp, said that the quarterback makes it so much more confidence in week one. That one intended for Seneca McKee, a beautiful ball. But the big wideout out of South Carolina not able to rein it down.
A little bit long and a little bit too much on a line. By the way, we should mention Jacob DeJesus. I really believe he's going to be... I'm going to call it a secret weapon. The secret will be out after the first couple of games. He was the best performer in the spring game. Cornell Ford told us he thought he was the best player in the program coming out of the spring. And he is 5'6 and 175 pounds and hard to catch, hard to see.
Another unique formation for UNLV as Brumfield rolls and fires complete to Landon Rogers, the Arkansas transfer, one of three Arkansas players to follow Barry Odom.
And Rogers is, you know, you have to have at least one big target in your wide receiver core. While they have a lot of dudes who are 5'8", 5'9", for the speed, Rogers is a really intriguing prospect, pushing 6'5", and showed good hands on that play.
Yeah, listed 6'4", 220. Would be surprised if he was a little bit bigger than both. Able to get it across the line to gain for the first down. Rebels approaching the red zone. Brumfield to air it out once more. A little bit too much air underneath it. That one way over the head of Ricky White, who led the team in receiving yards last year. Well, they've added a bunch of weapons. They always have 11 on the outside to go to.
Yeah, Ricky's a guy still with tremendous upside. He had a little bit of an uneven year last year. Got out to a really quick start, the transfer in from Michigan State. Everyone knows he's, you know, the most talented guy on the receiving corps. It's just about being consistent with his hands. And after the catch, too, he had a couple of fumbles last year. There were key losses in the middle of the field, so he's got to clean that up.
Second and 10 following the incompletion. Brumfield hands to Davis again. He's got some space around the outside. A touchdown saving tackle, but our first flag of the game. He's thrown around the 20-yard line. Lake Ellis eventually bringing down Davis. He likely saved six there.
Looks like there's a hole right in the middle. Or at least the left side of the line. Michael Oddie Jr., I think, was the nose tackle, was having his jersey prep.
Holding. Number 75 on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. Second down.
Ken Ray, the official, as Ben Silver held by Anton Ambule. The Rebels marching back. It'll be a second down and 20 upcoming. Some rotation around the offensive line as well.
Jet Thomas all alone in the backfield. Quick throw from Brumfield. It's to DeJesus. DeJesus couldn't get away from the tackler. Good job by Dante Lunin, senior out of Miami. Bring him down. Third down and long upcoming. This is going to be an interesting spot for offensive coordinator Brendan Marion, who's calling the plays. A lot's been said about Marion. Hired from Texas on his patented go-go offense. Third and 18. Brumfield to the end zone. It's caught. Was he in? No. Incomplete is the call. Ricky White couldn't drag the feet.
Man, Ricky broke open really quickly, and I thought Doug held it just a split second too long. He gets rid of that sooner, and that is a touchdown.
White with burner wheels, able to get past the coverage. Brumfield set the feet, fired an arcing ball.
Just not able to drag that foot. was Ricky White.
So this will be interesting. Jose Pisano, very accurate kicker, the transfer in from Missouri State. For long kicks, they may go with Andre Miano, but I think this is Pisano who's out there. This one's, what, 49?
48 yards, they'll call it. Pisano, 12 of 16 in field goals last year.
Review time.
Well, there was a catch in the Minnesota game last night, or was that two nights ago? Two nights ago. Against Nebraska. I watched it. I still don't know if it was Jackson, the wide receiver, if he got in. Because split second, he dragged the right foot. The left foot was coming down right at the same time.
Timeout, UNLV. It's their first of the half. 30 seconds in length.
So Barry Odom calls his first timeout. Gives us a chance before the 4th and 18 to look at some of this roster turnover. This is a new year for UNLV, a transformational year with the new coaching staff, 8 new position coaches, as well as Barry Odom. It's the largest
roster in school history, 110 players on the roster, exactly half, 55 of them newcomers.
Well, on one side, I'm glad they kept a lot of the players, the holdovers, from really the last 2 years. There are still some Tony Sanchez recruits on the roster. And Marcus Arroyo's crew brought in some really good players and some
high-profile transfer guys who needed 2 and 3 years to develop. But they gave the roster the spring, right? And they gave them the early part of the fall. And, you know, some guys elected to leave. And then it was time to start getting your own players, right, in certain positions. And in this 3-3-5 defense, they knew they wanted to load up the back end. So they were going to have 20 or 21 or 22 defensive backs. So that's where a lot of the transfers have come in. And they're high-profile guys. You know, a lot of players from Power 5 schools, and they've already blended in and, you know, made the ones and the twos.
So after the timeout, it'll be Pisano, who made 24 of his last 25 kicks in 4 years with the Bears of Missouri State in the FCS. This one from 48 yards. Pisano boots it. And it's good. That one sneaking through as Pisano gives the Rebels
a 17-0 lead. Talk about Andre Miona with the long leg. Pisano from 48, that
pretty
one
good.
Was solid.
Yeah, that was pretty good. And, you know, watching Jose in practice, he's got a little left-to-right movement. I wish that was me in golf. I have a lot of...
I meant right to left. A lot of right to left movement. His ball fades a little bit to the left. And that was plenty of distance. And it was hooking a bit, but he got it. Yeah, cleared by a lot.
So UNLV with 154 yards of total offense so far. Exactly 100 of them on the ground.
I was going to say, in the kicking game, never take it for granted. Because we could with the last 4 or 5 years with Goot to boot, right? Andy Gutierrez was money. Now, I think they've got a kicking combination here where they're going to be pretty solid. But that is, boy, that's a coach's nightmare. When you get into a season and all of a sudden, you know, you don't know what your kicking game is going to provide on field goals. So Miano should be out there. Yeah, he's out there. He's the long-distance kicker. James Shebest, the special teams coach, said as of about 2 weeks ago, Andre was about 50-60%, getting it all the way into the end zone. First kick he got into the end zone was about 3 yards deep, but they returned because Bryant has a very aggressive return game.
Anthony Frederick back for another kick return. Fourth in the country in average last year. He's got some space, but hammered just inside the 20-yard line. That's a special teams hit that'll hype up anybody as Dago Albert slams him down to the turf with the helmet.
You know, Albert's one of those guys, and like I said, a lot of the complimentary players, some of the special teamers, decided to leave the program after the spring. Albert's a guy they wanted. He stuck it out, and he really is. He's one of those key dudes on special teams where, you know, the rest of the game you may not hear a whole lot about them, but you have to have those gunners who are great tacklers. And remember, you know, for another guy locally who's, you know, made his way on special teams for a long time is Devon Walden Jr. Albert with the key play there.
So now Bryant looking for some offensive rhythm. 64 yards of total offense through their first 3 drives. And a flag on the field from the defensive backfield as the play clock ran out. You never want to see that on the first play of a drive.
So right now the game might seem out of hand, but...
Delay of game, number 4 on the offense, 5 yards, still first down.
There's a lot more to the story than just a 17-0 score. Eckhouse has been good. He's been very efficient. He's 7-9 for 55 yards. They haven't had much on the ground, and they've had trouble, you know, late, the third and fourth down in terms of converting. If they convert those, this can still be a very dangerous Bulldog team.
He gives up the middle to Faris Mukendi, a Canadian who battled injuries all of last year to get the start this year. He's upended by Thomas Anderson, the corner. Bryant with a ton of offense at the FCS level last year. School record, 429 yards per game average. They averaged 316 yards per game through the air. They've also averaged 30 or more points per game as a team for the last three seasons in total. First quarter is winding down. Eckhouse evades the pressure, somehow able to find a man over the middle. Brought down at the 30-yard line. That's Landon Ruggieri. Eckhouse somehow able to get out of that pressure. That'll bring up another pivotal third down for UNLV. They've done a good job so far of keeping Bryant in their own half of the field, but they'll have to do it in
the second quarter. So far, so good as the 56th season of UNLV football has started off in a swinging fashion. 17-0 Rebels after a quarter.
People often ask us why we take everything about every case so personally and why we're so tough on insurance companies.
Every client, every case matters, and we investigate every fact, every circumstance, and every detail so that you get every dollar you deserve.
That's because we're fighting for people's lives, for their families, and for their future. And things must be done right.
That's who we are. That's what we do.
Hennison Haight. Help is here.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority. And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support.
What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Hello, I am Nikki Fargus, president of the Las Vegas Aces. I am proud to support the mission of Nevada Donor Network by sharing the need to register to be an organ, eye, and tissue donor. Right now, over 30,000 African Americans are waiting to receive a life-saving organ. You can help provide hope to those waiting simply by registering to be a hero. Nevadans are giving, and together we can save lives. Join us at wearenevadans.org.
When we take the road less traveled, we cross barriers, shift the narrative, and play by our rules.
We don't fear the big moments.
Take your shot.
Cheer for each other.
And always drive for change. Because when we go all in, we are unstoppable. You catching on?
UNLV football brought to you by Parkway Tavern,
official partner of UNLV Athletics and your home of Rebels on the road with over 250 beers, 24/7 gaming, and 5 valley locations. There's no better place to catch the game than Parkway Tavern. Getting set to get it underway at the start of quarter number 2. Along with Steve Cofield, I'm Matt Neverett from Allegiant Stadium. This game, at least on paper, has been all UNLV so far in their opening game matchup against the Bulldogs of Bryant. The Rebels 9-4 against FCS opponents, dating back 20 years. Third down and 4 for Bryant. First play of the second quarter features Levy Eckhouse dropping back, firing on a slant route. And across the line to gain is Landon Ruggieri, the former walk-on, the favorite target of Eckhouse. He's able to get the first down. That's the fifth of the game for Bryant. UNLV defense sinking back just a little bit there, Steve. A little bit more than we've seen them so far today.
Yeah. You can see a little more rotation on defense. Jet Elad
getting some time in Jonathan Baldwin's spot. Eckhouse gives to McKendy. McKendy brought down around the line to gain. That was Elad in on the tackle. It'll go as a first down. And new
in the college football world this year, rule where the clock will not stop on first downs except for in the final 2 minutes of the second and the fourth quarters. What kind of an impact do you think that'll have on some of these games, especially early in the year while there's still the adjustment period?
I think offenses will adjust, right? There's going to be a lot more up-tempo to make sure they get to their average. I think the national average was just under 70 plays per game. I know the goal of Brennan Marion is 73 plays a game.
Ruggieri hammered. That was Woodard coming across. You don't want to hear those footsteps coming at you if you're a receiver in the defensive backfield. And Wooder, the Little Rock native, the Arkansas transfer. Just 7 tackles last year, but followed Barry Odom to UNLV and sung the praises of his head coach all offseason.
And they like him. They like him a lot. As a preferred walk-on, he just could not break through against or past
some of the more experienced scholarship players at Arkansas. But talking to Michael Shear, he said he was right on the edge of playing Jackson Woodard. He knows he can play.
And Barry Odom said that Woodard epitomizes the three pillars of his team: hard, smart, and tough. Up the middle is Mukendi running into Woodard and Williams.
It'll be another third down upcoming. 1 for 4 so far, Bryant Bulldogs on third down.
Yeah, getting things going here on the ground. One, not only to gain some yardage, but this should also open things up a little more for the passing game, which was pretty damn good in the fourth quarter. So multifaceted offense here from Bryant should make him more effective the rest of the way. We'll see what the adjustments are from Shear and his defense.
Raisin Cane's third down upcoming. Third down and 3 to go is Bryant into UNLV territory. Simi Bakar in the backfield. He's got it. He's stuck near the line of scrimmage. And that's where he's brought down. 4th and 3 upcoming for the Bryant Bulldogs. This UNLV front, we'll call it 6, has been stellar so far.
That was Tad Martinson again on the bottom of the pile. Big number 98 at 6'1 and 300 pounds. Got great depth on the defensive line.
And trailing by 3 possessions,
Chris Merritt's going to elect to go for it here once more. Formation spread wide open on 4th and 2. Every time they've gone for it on 4th down. Press coverage across the board for the Rebels and a false start. That's the left guard, Michael McNish.
That could change the decision. Dropping him back 5 yards. Look at Eckhouse. Eckhouse upset with his left guard.
Start. Number 68 on the offense. 5 yards. Still 4th down.
Steve, those are the kinds of mistakes that you'll see way more here in week 1 than you will in week 10, 11, 12.
That's a killer. You're having trouble keeping pace. You're finally on the move. The run game's producing. Then you don't get a chance to get a very makeable first down.
Ethan Getman, the place kicker, also handles punting duties for the Bulldogs as Jacob DeJesus, with his heels planted at the 8, back to receive the punt. A high boot with the left foot of Getman. Letting it go smartly into the end zone was DeJesus. A nice fake out as he came to the near side as well. So the first punt of the game either way is a touchback. Rebels taking it over next, leading by a trio of scores.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you, and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Las Vegas! Your world champion Las Vegas Aces are headed to T-Mobile Arena for the final regular season home game. Sunday, September 10th at noon. Let's pack T-Mobile Arena and send the Aces to the playoffs in style. Fan Appreciation Day, and you don't want to miss it. Tickets start at just $10. Great seats are still available. Visit LasVegasAces.com.
Make this the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals, IBEW Local 357, and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
UNLV football is brought to you by Finley Chevrolet, located in the southwest at 215 and South Rainbow, Nevada's number one Chevrolet volume dealership. And by Howard Hughes, there's something beautiful happening in Las Vegas, life in Summerlin. A premium master plan community designed to live as good as it looks. Find your new home at summerlin.com. Rebels take over for their first possession of quarter number two. On top by 17 in the opening game against Bryant to kick off the 2023 season. So far, so good. A lot of chunk plays for this offense. Got Donovan Lester, they call him the Senator in the backfield.
Lester's got it. He's across the 25. Wrapped up at the 26. Dante Lunin in on the stop. And as the Rebels work it quickly. Taking a look at the tenets of the go-go offense, invented by offensive coordinator Brendan Marion,
he featured three pillars: misdirection, unbalanced formation, and vertical shots. We've certainly seen the first two thus far. Another give, trying to stretch the edge is Donovan Lester, but he's brought down, maybe losing one after wrapped up by Lunin.
Yeah, the vertical part in the deep shots is, that's kind of the next step for Doug Brumfield. He had a little bit of effectiveness with that last year, but I think that's what Marion's been working on with Doug Brumfield as much as anything, is having enough confidence to throw to both sides of the field. And as Marion said, he brought in a lot of guys with speed, a lot of little guys. Let's get on the ball downfield.
Rebels 3-4 on third down so far. This one third and four to go. The lefty Brumfield fires it over the middle. It's off the hands of the intended target. He was past the line to gain, but Timothy Connerly unable to squeeze it. Fourth and four upcoming. And here comes the punt unit for the first time.
Yeah, one of those little guys with a ton of speed. 5'9 and about 180.
You see the shot of the exterior of Allegiant Stadium. Never been more thankful to be in a dome calling a game as I am today.
You know, it's funny. When I was
looking up or getting up this morning and kind of thinking about the day and saw the clouds, I was like, wow, this is cool that we are indoors. And in the past, I thought, hey, that's great because of the weather, because you generally, we're talking about hot weather, but not rainy weather. So
I mean, you hear football weather. I'll tell you what, personally, I'm fine with it being 70 degrees in air condition. Blake Ellis, the top cornerback for Bryant, being helped off the field. Brandon Ruggieri back to receive the punt. It'll be Marshall Nichols, a sophomore transfer from Mississippi State, his second year with the punting duties for UNLV. Under pressure, but he's able to get it off. Ruggieri inside the 35 dives, but he's able to stop it, more so smother it at 33. Bryant's second possession of the second quarter. We'll go from left to right. Well, so far so good for this UNLV defense, allowing just
109 yards total, just 41 on the ground. They've been stifling to this point.
Going back to Nichols, that turned out to be, 41, 42 yards on the punt. They did get some pressure, and that is one of the things that James Shebess, the
special teams coach, said. You know, Nichols, very talented, very strong leg. Got to speed up the release a couple times, especially against Notre Dame. He got blocked twice, so got to fix that and then make up for things with a big hang time.
Brian trying to get some offensive rhythm as they give to Simi Bakar. Down after a gain of two. Here's McDuffie and Turner in on the tackle. Simi Bakar actually played under Barry Odom for 2 years at Mizzou before transferring to Fresno State. Bakar playing for Bryant this year as a grad student, but having spent 2 years under Barry Odom, Barry and this defensive staff have a little bit more of a scouting report in week one on this guy than they would on a different team. Second down and 8. UNLV with 5 defensive backs on the field. Bryant spreading the formation here. Man in motion is Ruggieri. Eckhouse pulls it in. He'll run it himself.
Brought down by a couple of defenders. Brought down at the 40-yard line. Jonathan Baldwin and Marcel McDuffie running into him. Looked like Eckhouse ran into the back of one of his own players as well.
Maybe a little butt tackle.
He was in the middle of the slide as well before
he ran into the back of Powell.
I think he was looking to go down.
So fourth defender in on the play for UNLV. How about that? So here's a big stop here. I want to keep Bryant out of UNLV territory. Another Raisin Cane's third down. With Kyle Chikanowski, running back, split to the left. Trips at the top of the screen as Chikanowski's got the ball, pushing the pile. How about that movement as he gets it across for the first down?
Good drive there because Shelton had him at the line and he dragged him another 3 yards.
Tough to drag the 6'2", 235-pounder Elijah Shelton. That's just what Kyle Chikanowski, who's just 5'10", 185, did. One name we haven't called yet, Steve, Xavier Carter, who is expected to get a ton of playing time. The LSU transfer trying to find a way to slot into this defense.
I feel like there hasn't been a lot of third and long situations so far, and that would be his specialty.
Especially in terms of setting the edge on those plays. Chikanowski with it and across the 50. Good run. As he's brought down by Woodard holding on to the jersey.
Yeah, Carter's the kind of guy who's, you know, projectable at 6'4", 215 to probably get up to 235, 240.
The coaching staff has often made comparisons to Drew Sanders, who's now in the NFL, who's around 6'5", 235, and was a really big star on the edge for Arkansas. So he's not Drew Sanders now, but eventually they're hoping that he can build into that. But they said his pass rush instincts are good, and he's got, you know, multiple moves on the edge.
Tough to teach a frame like that, right? Second down and 3. Eckhouse goes to the far side. That's his favorite target, Ruggieri, and he's able to spin past a tackler and across for the first down. Ruggieri, with 65 receptions last year, setting a new Bryant Bulldogs record. He's already well on his way. That's his 6th of the game already. Ruggieri, the senior out of Yorktown Heights, New York. First team all Big South last year. 65 catches, 6 touchdowns. Leading returning touchdown scorer as well for this Bryant team.
Play action. Eckhouse slides up in the pocket. He'll tuck it and take it himself. He gets past Woodard inside the 30. Tries to make a juke to the outside. But he's wrapped up and brought down inside the red zone. It was Thomas Anderson combining with Woodard to save the touchdown run.
Heads up play. And then as he was making his move, Woodard stepped in the bucket to the left, right? A little baseball reference there for you, Matt. And then was caught. He couldn't shift position to get back to his right.
Kind of no man's land was the Little Rock native.
Good speed.
So now inside the NV Energy red zone for the second time is Bryant. Wide open formation. Both of these teams like to run a ton of plays. Eckhouse slides up again. He's across the line of scrimmage, cutting inside the 10. He's wrestled down by Woodard, playing that spy role as we had mentioned early on.
Yeah, he is getting a lot of time behind this line. And keep in mind, it is a veteran offensive line, all 5 starters back. And, you know, when you look up and down the Bryant line, you'd expect, well, FCS was a bunch of dudes who are like 260 pounds. No, they're a big offensive line, 293, 300, 310, 335, and 300 pounds. So they can push it.
Kind of funny, they're only
linemen under 300 pounds is their left tackle. Usually that's your biggest. 10 of 11 starters returning this season on offense for Bryant. Eckhouse gives it up the middle again. Nearly wrapped up in the backfield, but able to push through is Chikanowski. Martinson and Thomas Anderson combining for the stop once more.
Second down and goal to go for the Bulldogs as the clock approaches 5 minutes here in the first half.
Yeah, doing a good job of controlling things, tiring out the defense for the game. Rebels with the sizable lead at 17-0, but Bryant's actually outgaining them by a 169-160 count.
Part of it, the Rebels haven't had too many long, sustained drives because of the big chunk plays they've been able to garner. on the 7. Eckhouse looking end zone, throws behind the receiver. And Dre Williams, right place, right time. They were looking for Powell.
That was a brutal throw.
Second time we've seen Eckhouse airmail one way behind a receiver. Dre Williams nearly walked into the pick there. So third down and goal, the Rebels going to bring their heavy package in on the defensive line. Wholesale changes. As four big men come in, and there's Xavier Carter.
Well, Brian is 2 of 6 on third down, and you're right, left defensive end. We'll see if Xavier Carter can put some pressure.
Keith Conley, big 99 on the other side, checking in for the first time as well. Third and goal from the 7. Eckhouse looks for a receiver, gets away from the pressure.
And he's smothered. Going to bring him down at the 2-yard line. It was Dre Williams and Fred Tompkins who came in from the sideline. Fighting for the stop, and now it's a decision for Chris Merritt here. Fourth down and goal to go from the 2. Looks like they're going to go for it. Eckhouse showing off the wheels this afternoon. A little bit of toughness there as he took a big shot. So here we go. Ryan Clark split behind Eckhouse in the pistol. Fourth and goal from the 1.5-yard line. Eckhouse holds it. He is swallowed up. That was Dre Williams for pay dirt. The Rebels force another turnover on downs. They'll take over deep in their own territory.
Great pressure, great read. Marcel McDuffie in there early as well.
Just nowhere for Eckhouse to go.
Summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet, like the Pilot and Passport Trail Sport and the Ridgeline, built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Want to study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
Hey, John. It's Tuesday, and we're still selling lots of cars.
That's right, Steph.
We know how to make everything super easy. From a customer's arrival, purchasing a new vehicle, or servicing an existing one.
John.
That's right, Steph. In fact, we sell the most cars every day of the week, even on a Tuesday.
UNLV football is brought to you by Intermountain Health. Hello, Las Vegas. Hello, sunset over the strip. We're Intermountain Health, and we're here to be a part of your Las Vegas life. And we're here to help you live an even healthier one. Intermountain Healthcare, the official health partner of UNLV Athletics. Well, the Rebels taking over deep in their own territory after stuffing the Bulldogs on fourth down. This will be the worst starting field position for UNLV, but it'll come after a big stop. Donovan Lester with the ball, and it's about 2 yards before he's wrestled down.
I mean, those are so big. Those are game-changing plays. That's, 3 of 10, Brian, is on third and fourth down. And I thought the last couple of years, a lot of these defensive players were part of a culture that really stepped up in short-yarded situations on third and fourth down.
There's Lester again, dragging a trio of tacklers
along with him. He's across for the first down. Yep. Tyler Haskins along for the ride defensively.
6'2", 215, just muscle upon muscle, 7% body fat. He can run with power and he can run with speed.
Not only the tangibles, but the relationship with Brennan Marion. He spent the 2019 season as the offensive coordinator at William & Mary. Donovan Lester. There's Jet Thomas, the tailback, who recorded his first collegiate touchdown already today.
You want to win those last 4 minutes of the first, come out strong in the 4 minutes after. So key 8-minute group here, and they're off to a good start on this drive after they were on, or at least they're back to the end zone.
UNLV got the opening kickoff, so adds even more pressure to this drive. Brumfield escapes a couple of tacklers, but he's swallowed up at the 20. Doug brought down quickly as he tried to rush that one. Michael Audi upending him. A third down for UNLV.
They are 3 of 5 in terms of converting the third downs today. In an area of success as they look to the sideline and get the play call. Always interested to see how different teams signal in the plays. Brennan Marion with as unique an offense as anybody
at the FBS level. Calling plays is his first year at the offensive coordinator spot. On third down, Brumfield fires. It's tipped up in the air. And it's brought down for an interception. College rules, you're down once you touch the turf. As that was Robert Crockett III bringing it down off the tipped ball. Dante Lunan got a hand on it. Brumfield.
The ruling on the field is an interception.
Brumfield looking for the man over the middle. Lunan got the hand. Crockett brought it home. Some of the rules changes around college football. That's not one that they updated. Once you're down, you're down. You don't have to get up and run it if you're Crockett there. But the preparedness for the next level, though, is Brumfield throws his first pick of the year off of a tipped ball. He threw just 5 all of last season. So after the first interception for Brumfield, Bryant takes over
in UNLV territory. 17-0. UNLV on top with just over 2 to play in the first half.
The Avondros, that's the first day.
First one
out. No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota's led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We've made the best memories and lasting friendships from the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
A personal injury attorney, trust is so important.
Trust isn't given, it's earned.
You want someone that will be with you every step of the way, someone you trust with your health and your future.
Someone with integrity and the experience to get you the settlement you deserve.
And we believe trust means putting our clients' interests first.
And that's what we do every day.
Hennessy Haight, help is here.
When we take the road less traveled, we cross barriers, shift the narrative, and play by our rules. We don't fear the big moments. Take your shot. Cheer for each other. And always drive for change. Because when we go all in, we are unstoppable. You catching on?
A rainy day outside here in the season opening UNLV contest, but it's a beautiful Las Vegas afternoon inside Allegiant Stadium. Split sight of the UNLV Rebels, and of course, the Las Vegas Raiders. Rebels on top 17-0, but committing their first turnover of the year. It's a
Brumfield pass tipped and intercepted. Game management at a key here with just over 2 to play in the first half. Maybe Eckhaus. Firing as he's hit. This one's in the end zone.
Who's going to come up with it? Nobody, as it falls harmlessly to the turf. That one a dangerous and well-thrown ball intended for Anthony Frederick. Jerry Williams got a hand on it.
Yeah, I thought the coverage by Dre was really good. Kind of an ill-advised throw. He took a shot. Also got hit a split second after. And it was on the mark, but Dre with a nice breakup there.
Great
you know,
throw.
Going back to Brumfield's interception, probably one you need to tuck and run quickly. There were two Bryant defenders around the receiver, and then, as you mentioned, Lunin came in the foreground and tipped it as a it was like an Aroldis Chapman fastball attempt to throw to Ricky White and really never got to him, at least in clean fashion.
Just under two to play in the half. Clock will stop on first downs with under two to play as Bryant forced to call a timeout with the play clock expiring. They already had the delay of game earlier. That was on the first play of a drive, and now having to burn a timeout.
It's their first of the half.
And their first
30 seconds
to avoid another penalty. Already a couple of false starts in the game as well. Definitely a week one matchup across all of college football, as we've already had some really interesting games across the Mountain West as well. And really excited to have not only
UNLV football back, but college football in general.
Hey, good games today. Colorado, surprising. TCU, Fresno, not surprising Purdue because that was a very close spread, but if anyone thought that Fresno was going to go bye-bye and sink to the bottom of the Mountain West Conference standings because of Jake Haener exiting to the NFL, not going to happen. Mikey Keene, the transfer in from Central Florida, was awesome today. I think he finished with over 300 yards and four touchdowns and no INTs. And good environment here at Allegiant Stadium. Still amazing when you look to your left in the lanai doors, when you look out and you're like, my God, there is an NFL-sized stadium. UNLV plays college football here, and you can see, you know, the Luxor and Mandalay Bay. It's something we never dreamed of here, to have 65,000-seat stadium with a strip view.
One of the most unique and well-funded college football stadiums across the country. Second down and 10 for Eckhaus coming out of the timeout. Pass complete underneath to the tight end, Jahad Edmond.
He is crushed, and he's down on the turf. That was Williams and McDuffie combining on the hit.
That's unfortunate. He got banged in the knee, but when you got a big fella coming at you, Jare Williams plays it smart, goes low, and took him out, and Jare celebrated a little bit.
That's one of the only ways to bring down the 6'2", 245-pound senior. Got to go low. That's what football rulemakers nowadays, they'd much rather have you make that tackle than leave your feet on a head-to-head collision.
You don't want to go above the shoulders. Hawaii got kind of buried defensively last night after like the midway point of the third quarter. They lost two of their best defenders on targeting calls. And I'm not saying this is absolutely the case, but I think officials are kind of teed up in those first couple of weeks to send that message. Hey, guys, got to remind you, do not go for the head. So ejections are a little more plentiful in the first couple of weeks.
It's similar to college basketball, the NCAA level, where the officials have points of emphasis, and you really see them way more at the beginning of the year than late in the schedule. And player safety, one of the points of emphasis for NCAA officials this year. And Jahad Edmond did pop up. And he looks to be in some real serious pain. He's unable to put any weight on it after going back down.
You know, we've talked about a lot of cross-training with the Rebels and, you know, much deeper at the two level. Give a shout out to Anton Ambule. Yeah, he's having a lot of trouble getting off the field.
But Ambule for the Rebels is playing a lot of left tackle. Kid out of Calabasas, was kind of buried deep on the depth chart last year. Young guy, I think he still has all 4 years of eligibility left. And he's a dude who in fall camp worked a lot, kind of worked his way up, you know, playing right tackle, and then when Jalen St. John got a little beat up. So Ambule's going to get a lot of time today, so keep an eye on number 75 on the left side.
2-for-7 on third downs are the Bryant Bulldogs. Eckhaus changing the call at the line of scrimmage. With 1:32 to go in the first half. He's got a man. It's under pressure, and it's incomplete. How about the coverage there by Thomas Anderson?
Yep, Anderson, another one of the imports. They wanted to have a lot of numbers at defensive back. He worked his way up to win that cornerback job. And, you know, when you look at, say, 5 years ago in the defensive backfield, Matt, for the UNLV football program, and you look at it now,
you know, the shortest guys are about 5'11", right? Jare's a little bit short at 5'10". The rest of the crew, like Anderson, 6 foot, 6'1", 6'2". So much bigger in the defensive backfield and bringing the hammer on certain plays as well.
Done a good job of mixing up and disguising the coverages as well.
Uh-oh.
This punt goes through the hands of Getman, and this will be a huge loss on fourth down, and Gettman slow to get up. UNLV excited as could be. They'll take over on the Bryant 36.
He just missed it. I thought the long snapper may have snapped it prematurely, but he just missed it. Got to look it into the mitts.
A 22-yard loss on fourth down will give UNLV a short field with a 1:22 to play in the half. That's a gift.
Yeah. You throw the INT, you get fortunate on special teams, and I talked about winning those last 4 minutes of the first half and the first four of the second half. Here's a chance to get a victory, and these four set up in really good territory here at about the 37-yard line of Bryant.
Reese and Thomas, the two running backs, both split to Brumfield's left. You'll see a lot of these unique formations in the go-go offense. And a false start call on the outside.
False start. Number 70 on the offense. 5 yards. Still first down.
And that was the right tackle, Tiger Shanks, 6'5 senior out of Oregon. So still a short field, but now back to the 42-yard line.
Brumfield on the Rebels offense. Two timeouts remaining. You got the formation spread way outside. Brumfield keeps it on the option. Cuts it back to the near side. He's tripped up and somehow able to keep his feet. Getting all the way to the 35-yard line. A gain of 7 on first down.
Yeah, I thought he made one cut too many, but still got positive yards by moving ahead. And RPO absolutely has to be part of the game because Doug Brumfield is a good run threat.
Clock winding down with under a minute to go. Brumfield to pass on second down. Cuts it outside. It's around a defender.
Yep.
Able to get out of bounds inside the 30. They'll mark him down at the 29. They're down in 2 yards. Upcoming, that was Tyler Haskins forcing Brumfield out of bounds. 50 seconds to play, third down and 2. How aggressive are you here?
17-0 lead. Super aggressive. I believe Brendan Marin is an aggressive offensive coordinator. Right?
I think they're trying to score a touchdown here. There's no need to settle for a field goal unless they get in a bad situation.
The give is to Thomas. Gets around the defender. Cuts it back. Inside the 25. Dragging a couple of defenders with him. Brought down at the 21. Clock will stop until
the chains are set. Schillingford and Yates combining for the stop.
That was a hell of a run. Because he was stopped. Ran right into Jack Haas. And then kind of picked his way through the defense for a good game.
That's your playground run for the freshman Jet Thomas, who's still in the game. On field.
Uh-oh.
Smothered. Nowhere to go. Kenny Dyson, the captain, defensive end, able to bring down Brumfield on first down. And UNLV calls the timeout to stop the clock with 28 to go.
I'll make an old reference, if that's okay. It's kind of going Fran Tarkenton there.
Okay.
Right? Spinning, turning, and then just finally turned the wrong way. Dyson is like, hello, I'm here. You're going nowhere.
Dyson vacuumed him up there. His 8.5 sacks last year was second in the
Time
Big
out.
South. First team all conference a year ago was Kenny Dyson.
Second of the half, 1 minute in lane.
Barry Odom calls timeout to stop the clock.
Well, as we're approaching the halftime break, 28 seconds to go here in quarter number two, a 17-0 lead. But the game is a lot more even if you take out that first quarter.
Yes, and if you, for Bryant, could take out all the short yard stops by UNLV.
Their defense, when it's had to come up big, has been really good in pressure situations. And then, you know, that mistake on a punt is inexcusable. But, yeah, this is, could Bryant come back and win this game? Absolutely. They've been able to move the ball pretty consistently. Dangerous pass game, you pointed out, Ruggieri. Reliable receiver. The run game got going a little better in the second quarter. And there's been a, while UNLV has had the big chunk plays, there's been a little less rhythm to the offense as the game has moved along towards the half here.
And I think with a new offensive system like this, obviously going to take a couple of weeks to really get it down in terms of getting the communication. That's the biggest thing with the new system, is getting the play itself called to the players on the field.
Well, you've got a new offense, and as you mentioned, you have the tenets of the go-go in front of you there.
Misdirection, unbalanced formation, vertical shots.
Right, so the unbalanced formation, but especially the misdirection.
That does take reps, and there's only so much you can do in fall camp going against your own defense. By the way, you're not facing a 3-3-5 anymore, right? So that's a little bit different. And we mentioned all the player turnover and roster turnover. There's a lot of new guys. So you got a new offense, and there's a lot of new players on the offense. So that is going to take some time to work the things out.
Well, we've got a delay here, not only because of the timeout on the field, but because of torrential downpours outside. There's a stream of water coming down inside the red zone. So this is not something, A, that we see weather-wise a lot in Las Vegas, but B, even more rare inside of an indoor stadium.
I could just see anyone my age and older right now sitting on the couch going, wait, there's a little bit of water draining down on the field, and they can't play. My guess is they want to make sure that nothing more serious is going to happen to the roof here at Allegiant. Check things out that it's safe out there, but I've never heard of that one.
Well, it's all about.
Although we used to have, and I say we, like the football community, I feel like they did have issues at the old Humphrey Dome in Minneapolis
sometimes with weather. You're not supposed to, but.
Theirs was
more. I think they had a massive collapse.
Well, theirs was more due to the weight of the snow, yeah. But for those unaware or not in Las Vegas, the last 2 days, we have had torrential downpours, historic rain for Southern Nevada standards.
AAA affiliate of the Oakland Athletics here in Las Vegas, the Las Vegas Aviators out in Summerlin on the west side of town, had to postpone a game due to rain for the first time in 4 years last night. That's how you know it's bad, when they got to postpone a game in Summerlin. So we've got a brief pause in the game as they try to rectify this issue. But one note that we did see, and Chris Merritt not going to be excited about this one. Jihad Edmond, the tight end who was injured, down in a heap on the field, just carted off the field and into the locker room. So I would say there's a very slim chance that we see him back here in this week one matchup. But all in all for UNLV, as you mentioned, the big chunk plays have played a part. They're averaging 9 yards a play through the air, 8.5 per play on the ground, and that's including that nearly 70-yard touchdown run on the first play from scrimmage.
Yeah, VD, Vincent Davis, the transfer from Pitt, with a bust out for 69 yards.
Jaden Thomas, 18-yarder. By the way, almost completely irrelevant note that I will mention. Believe it or not, there's actually two Jaden Thomases out of Atlanta playing FBS football. The other one with a different spelling on Jaden.
Playing for Notre Dame at wide receiver. About a 6'1", 215 wide receiver.
So if your name is Jaden Thomas, you've got a pretty good shot to play some high-level football.
I just want to get this Jaden Thomas the attention he deserves. And maybe that's why in high school he was Jet, right? To differentiate. He's fast, so he deserves the name Jet. But he had an 18-yarder. And then I'll tell you, the other guy, we'll jump ahead to talk about keys in the second half. Jacob DeJesus had a 29-yard reception. I think they really have to get him involved, whether it's out of the backfield or something on short passes. He's so explosive. I'd love to see Jacob DeJesus get at least 10 touches combined somehow in the second half.
And DeJesus was a guy, not only the coaching staff singing his praises during the offseason, but other players at different positions saying that that was the number one guy that they were most excited with his performance at camp.
Well, one, he's a guy you want to root for, right? He's listed at 5'6", and we're very big on
judging heights and weights, so we can both work on the surface, right, at some point. I actually think he's a little smaller than 5'6", which is incredible. We see Deuce Vaughn right now, you know, trying to make it big in the NFL at Kansas State. With Dallas, he's only 5'5", but Jacob, he's a small guy, but he's pretty thick. But, you know,
clearly he's a dude who was under-recruited. He's been under-recruited his entire life. He's out of a JUCO in California, but, man, he's electric. And the other thing that a lot of people mention, and I think this is where he really won people over, it's not only the explosiveness, the elusiveness, but he also carries himself a certain way. He's already come in and been a leader from a work ethic standpoint. So I'd love to see him featured a lot in the second half. And as we mentioned in the spring game, I mean, he was just about unstoppable. I think he wound up having 12 or 13 catches, had even more targets. So let's look for Jacob DeJesus down the stretch here, see what he can do if he gets the ball, and certainly in the second half.
Looks like they're good to go down on the field again. A brief pause because of the heavy rain outside forcing its way through the roof here at brand new Allegiant Stadium. Rebels won 5 of their last 8 games here. $2 billion, 65,000 capacity stadium that opened as the home of the Las Vegas Raiders.
Just a couple of years ago, It looks like they're going to play through. UNLV with a second down upcoming just outside the red zone. They'll snap it from the 28-yard line. And it'll be a second down and 17 with
28 seconds to go here in second quarter of play. And for the first time tonight, nobody in the backfield with Doug Brumfield. He's got two receivers each side and a tight end to the right. So after the brief pause, we're back underway. Lefty Brumfield fires it over the middle. It's caught by McKee. He's inside the NV Energy red zone. The Rebels have to get to the line here with under 20 to play in the half.
You can see Seneca has really earned the trust of Doug Brumfield. They've been together for a couple of years, and big play there.
UNLV needs to get this play off. 10 to go in the second quarter. This could be the last play of the first half. It will be as Brumfield takes it himself. He's going for the corner. Doug in. Touchdown. UNLV on the final play of the second quarter. What a run by Doug Brumfield, making it happen all on his own. A 15-yard scramble for his first rushing
touchdown of the year.
Right about here, I'm like, get out of bounds, get out of bounds. But the clock was running out, and Doug turned down the jets. You know, guys who are 6'5", 6'6", they get out in the open field. You know defenders are going to misjudge their speed. His stride is so long, and then the physicality of Doug Brumfield is up to about
217 now, working with Jeff Fish, the new strength and conditioning coach. That is massive. That is a massive way to close out the half.
With time winding down, that was going to be their last opportunity regardless. Pisano's extra point is up and in, and that's the first half of the 2023 season. So far, so good for UNLV. Led it 17 to nothing after the first quarter, 24 to nothing at the half. Steve, your thoughts?
Great job on the ground. Great job in clutch moments like that one. And then the defense, I thought, was a star in moments where they needed to make stops. They made them.
Doug Brumfield leading his troops into the locker room. Barry Odom enters his first halftime as the head coach of UNLV with a 24 to nothing lead. The Rebels solid both on offense and defense as we enter the halftime break.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean?
A healthier, stronger you, and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet. Like the Pilot and Passport Trailsman and the Ridgeline. Built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda. The most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority. And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Want to study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty? Or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
How can I explain myself?
We'll be right back.
Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals, IBEW, Local 357, and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
This is the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
Confronting drought, drop by drop, harnessing the sun at the atomic level, partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce, improving public health, combating poverty, uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, Rebels make it happen.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet, like the Pilot and Passport Trailsman and the Ridgeline. Built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority. And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
You said you'd never me.
Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals, IBEW Local 357, and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
This is the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
Confronting drought, drop by drop, harnessing the sun at the atomic level, partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce, improving public health, combating poverty, uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, rebels make it happen.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet, like the Pilot and Passport Trail Sport and the Ridgeline, built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority. And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
Thank you.
Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals IBEW Local 357 and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
This is the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
Confronting drought, drop by drop, harnessing the sun at the atomic level, partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce, improving public health, combating poverty, uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, rebels make it happen.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust.
But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet, like the Pilot and Passport Trailsman and the Ridgeline, built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Sierra Air Conditioning makes quality service our top priority.
And that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning,
water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
Torrential downpour earlier, the rain's lightening up. Of course, we are indoors here at Allegiant Stadium as one half of the Barry Odom tenure as the head coach of UNLV is complete. UNLV enters into the second half with a 24-0 lead, along with Steve Cofield. I'm Matt Nevert coming to you from high above the playing surface. And Steve, in the first half that was dominated by UNLV, a lot to like overall.
Yeah, you see the rush numbers, 153 yards, some lightning plays on big runs of 69, 19, and 18. Kudos to the offensive line. This is a new center and then right side. I think Alani Macaelli's done a really good job at the guard position, and check that he's on the left side, but Haas at center, so they've opened up holes. And big stops from the D, you know, total yards for Bryant, 150, but it's when they got stopped on third and fourth down and the big goal line play where there was a jailbreak by the UNLV defense. And, you know, the other thing on defense, but for the most part, the tackling was pretty good. And
that's always something you worry about in the opening game, because they really don't get to, outside of a couple of scrimmages, smash each other, and you don't want that. So tackling is always a concern in game one. Good first half.
You mentioned the third and fourth downs. Bryant went for it a ton, especially on fourth down. 2 of 8 on third down, 1 of 4 on fourth down.
As we take a look at the halftime numbers presented by Findlay Chevrolet, and taking a look at the first half highlights, the scoring got started right away. The first play of the season was a Vincent Davis 69-yard touchdown run, and they never looked back from there.
Yeah, VD was great with that 69-yard run. Here you see Doug Brumfield scrambling pretty wisely. Here's a great run after running into Jack Haas by Jet Thomas, who, that's a debut, right? 18-yard touchdown, but what a debut for the freshman out of Atlanta. The good hands man, Seneca McKee, with a catch, and he was the trusted receiver in the first half. And then here's Doug Brumfield. You want to talk about a momentum buster for Chris Merritt? That's got to be freaking heartbreaking going to the half. You played a competitive half. Listen, 17-0 ain't great being down, but to give up that touchdown because of a, you know, bunch of poor angles taken and a great play by Doug Brumfield,
that's got to hurt Bryant going into the locker room. And what a lift on the other side for UNLV. And then you see, again, the Vincent Davis 69-yard run. And I told you, you know, watching him walk up the tunnel before the game, maybe it was a cramp, right? He looked like he was limping on his right leg a little bit. And then all of a sudden, before we could even get going in the game, handoff, he goes 69.
And I thought that the rotation of running backs has been sturdy all the way across the board. They haven't given up anything when they bring in a new body into the backfield.
Now, you knew they were going to have at least 4 talented running backs out there, and Courtney Reese even got a carry, 1 carry for 5 yards, but yeah, Vincent Davis, that was it. That was the 1 carry, 69 yards, but a little more of the workhorse in Lester with 6 carries for 22. I have a feeling he'll be able to break a chunk playoff at some point. And DeJesus, not credited with a carry. It's always a little confusing on the jet sweeps or the toss forward. That was counted as a pass on that 29-yard gain. So, as I mentioned, going to the second half, I'd like to see DeJesus get the ball a little bit more. Maybe some more deep shots from Doug Brumfield. I know they want to work on that. And I think on the defensive side of things, on radio side, Tony Gordasco was told by Barry Odom that the defense does need to tighten up a little bit. I also think that they have to get a little more pressure on Zevi Eckhouse. So whether it's from the edge or up the middle, they got to get some wins on the defensive line.
And we should keep an eye on Jalen St. John, Matt, in the second half, because it looks like he might be out for the game.
The Rebels got the ball to start the game. The Bryant Bulldogs will get the ball to start the second half as Anthony Frederick is swallowed up around the 20-yard line, but there is a flag
near the 30-yard line. It was Rashad Tanner eventually bringing down the All-American kickoff returner from a year ago in Frederick.
See what the flag is here.
We'll await the call from Ken Ray, our referee.
During the return, holding number 15 on the return team, it'll be half the distance from the end of the run. First down.
So a costly penalty coming out of the half committed by Connor Lathrop. As we get a look at it here, and yeah, every referee in the country is going to call that one right in front of him.
Ball backed up all the way to the 9-yard line. So the coverage, I'm sure, made James Shebest, the special teams coach, happy with the tackle there at about the 16-17, and now it's backed up to the 9.
Considering they've been able to keep Anthony Frederick in check, that's a huge one. He had a 30-plus yard return in every game last year. Simi Bakar takes the first touch of the second half up to the 19-yard line
before he's stopped by Jackson Woodard. That's a name that we expected to call a lot on the defensive side, and we have. Woodard named a team captain in his first year in the Scarlet and Gray.
You know, another thing to look for on this defense is that they will have Woodard or someone else play a little more spy role against Eckhouse. The middle of the field
did open up about five or six times against the Rebel defense in half number one.
Jackson Woodard with a game-high nine tackles. Levi Eckhouse, the Culver City, California native, gets away from a defender and gets across the first down. And plenty more. Eckhouse cuts outside at the 50. He's knocked out of bounds at the 44. A long run before Jackson Turner is able to bring him down. And we want to talk about a field-flipping carry for Levi Eckhouse. It was Jalen Dixon that had him stopped in the backfield until Eckhouse spun out of the way.
Good speed. Good speed. A little power at the end there, too. It's a little hand work, a little hand fighting at the end of the play. Jackson Turner trying to take him down, gets him in the helmet.
Eckhouse approaching 90 yards rushing, 89 yards net after that long carry. He gives to a running back who's swallowed up in the backfield.
Who's there?
Just about everybody.
Yeah, Jarray Williams,
right? He broke the busted up the run play from the get-go, and then everyone else followed up. You know, I should mention I was going a million miles an hour there coming into the half. Jalen St. John is the left tackle. He's the highly touted transfer, 6'4", 335, former three, borderline four-star guy.
He was a little beat up during the fall, so I don't know his exact status now. But I thought Ambule, number 75, Anton Ambule came in and did a good job at a key position at left tackle the rest of the half.
Second down and 14, a loss of four for Sidney Bakar. Eckhouse moving once again, completes a pass inside the 40-yard line. That's his favorite target. It's Landon Ruggieri, Jonathan Baldwin on the coverage.
What do you think? They bring more pressure in the second half?
I think they're going to have to if Eckhouse is going to throw and run like this. He sent four there, and Eckhouse found the open man. Big third down stop upcoming. Mentioned it during the break, but Brian, 2 of 8 on third downs. In half number one, they have gone for it four times on fourth down as well. Looking four down territory here again. Eckhouse looking for a man. He's hit as he throws, and it's incomplete.
Jarray from his blind side, that screwed up the rhythm of the whole play.
We'll talk about bringing the pressure. Why not send Jarray Williams, team captain, on the contact? Bryant on to punt. Fourth down and 5 at their own 30, or the UNLV 39 rather.
This will be a short punt. I wonder how much the contact on the kicker punter Ethan Gettman on the last punt impacted this decision. He'll be out there to boot it away. Split back for the Rebels is Jacob DeJesus. This one's put in the air. DeJesus going to let it go. As a touchback falls into the end zone. That's one of the easier decisions for DeJesus. So the Rebels will take over following the touchback. First drive of half number two coming up.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you and healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
Here's the first customer that bought a car.
The Avondros, that's the first day.
First one out.
No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota has led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We've made the best memories and lasting friendships from the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
Our firm has always been right here in Las Vegas from the very beginning.
Yeah, we spent years getting to know the local insurance companies. They know us and they respect us.
We have deep roots in this city, and we'll take those long-time relationships and put them to work for you to get you the help and money you deserve.
Yeah, call us crazy, but when an accident happens in Vegas, we think your lawyer should be from Vegas, too.
Hennison Haight. Help is here.
Want to study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery?
It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other.
Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
UNLV football presented by Finley Toyota. After the game or anytime, visit or click on Finley Auto. Finley Toyota is the largest Toyota dealer in Nevada. Ask for John Barr. He'll do anything to sell you a car. Along with Steve Cofield, Matt Nevert from Allegiant Stadium. Rebels on top of the Bryant Bulldogs. 24-0 as UNLV takes over for the first time in half number two. Running the ball up the gut with a 24-point lead in this cavalry of running backs expected to get a lot of touches. That was Vincent Davis to get it started.
My timing was perfect. I was just checking downstairs with the radio sidelines. I'm like, is VD okay? Yeah, he's okay. He's back out there.
And not only is he all right, he's split back with Donovan Lester, who's got it now. Davis with a solid block to give Lester some space to the outside. And brought down just a couple yards short of the line to gain.
That was Dante Lunin tripping him up.
That was a hell of a tackle. Lunin was engaged with a blocker. He shed the blocker. I think that was Shelton Zeon, and then made a low tackle.
Seven tackles for Lunin to lead all Bulldog defenders.
Now here's a third and short as Brumfield goes under center. Switching things up a bit here in the offense. Play action, he'll keep it himself. Wide open is Ricky White, but he falls short of the first down marker. Nobody around him. That pass just corkscrewed him into the ground.
I mean, that was amazing deception in the backfield. It looked like three different guys could have gotten the ball. And then Ricky White, little behind him. And that's why, you know, it's one of those things that's not really kept track of. Those seem like really simple passes, short passes, the bubble screens, the great quarterbacks. And Doug has to get a little bit better at that. You got to be on the money because you can cost yourself extra yardage. And in that case, a first down.
Marshall Nichols puts it in the air for Landon Ruggieri. Their catch called for and received. Ball's going to be spotted at the 21-yard line. Marshall Nichols with his second punt of the game and with a 24-point lead.
Rebel defense back out onto the field. He's done a good job of swallowing up this running game, but Zemi Eckhouse finding ways to keep drives alive all on his own.
Well, if the Rebels go on to win this, that 47-yard run will absolutely be one of the points where the coaches can get on
the team a little bit. A lot of breakdowns on that run, and we'll see if they can clean that up. Not allow anything else super big against Eckhouse, who is fleet of foot and approaching 100 yards on the ground.
After a 53-yard punt from Marshall Nichols, here's Eckhouse leading the Bulldogs from left to right. Play action on the first play. Airs it out for Ruggieri, complete at the 45, and knocked out of bounds. A little pitch and catch between veteran Eckhouse and his favorite target, Ruggieri, before Anderson knocked him out. That's just an example there of Eckhouse waiting for the space to open up. Those corner routes, some of the toughest throws at the college level. Another first down for Brian. It's their 12th of the game. This is a Bulldog team that matches UNLV tempo-wise and has for the last couple seasons. In and out of the hands of the intended target. That was the Utah Tech transfer, Jalen Powell, dropping it.
Well, we put a little blame on Doug Brumfield for a pass that Ricky White couldn't haul in cleanly. That was not on Eckhouse. That was right there. Powell's got to make that catch.
So with all the work on the jugs machine in the offseason and working with the veteran quarterback is four.
Sets up a second down and 10. UNLV bringing everybody close to the line of scrimmage. Counts again on play action. He's got pressure. He fires. It's intercepted. Turned over by Thomas Anderson. His first interception with the UNLV Rebels presented by Belfort Property Restoration. Right to him. Great coverage by Anderson for the pick.
Rolling on the field is an interception.
Good. Good recognition by Thomas Anderson, because that was such bad communication. I'm not going to blame that one on Eckhouse. It looked like the receiver in that case turned in instead of turning out. But a lot of times, you know, those easy interceptions are the hardest ones to haul in. It sounds stupid, but you're so shocked by it, and all of a sudden you are a receiver and there's no one on you. Got to concentrate, haul the ball in, and Thomas Anderson, again, another one of those really good stories. So much turnover on
this roster. Anderson brought in a challenge in the defensive backfield, and he won the job.
Anderson, the transfer from Independence Community College in Kansas.
Here we go.
Wide open in some space. That was Jacob DeJesus, and they found some unique ways to get him the ball.
And Colin Elliott on defense for Bryant got shaken out of his you-know-what on that one.
That'll go as a reception for DeJesus once more. Jet Thomas looking for an edge and swallowed up by Javis Rayside, the strong safety. UNLV to the line with 9:35 to go here in the third quarter. Looking down on three upcoming. Thomas and Reese in the backfield. Really like the way that they've rotated these running backs in and out so far. Downfield directing traffic. Play clock at 15. Give us to the near side. Spinning away from a tackler and getting the first down. Not out of bounds by Javis Rayside. That's Jet Thomas once again. Thomas with his sixth carry of the game, pushing him over 40 yards on the contest in his college debut.
Impressive prospect. We knew about the speed.
A little bigger than I thought he was. Listed at 5'10", 180. He's a thick dude, even at 18, 19 years old.
Able to scamper for the first down. Field fakes the play action to Jet Thomas. He'll go to the near sideline looking for Courtney Reese.
And that throw a bit over his head. Crowd opining for a potential pass interference call, but that one an uncatchable ball from the start.
Again, though, good deception, right? Two backs in the backfield. Jet Thomas was the short outlet. And Courtney Reese running a sort of wheel route. Good coverage by Bryant, though.
The tight end, Kaleo Ballengai, in for the first time on the far side. Blocking on a run play. And smothered at the line of scrimmage. Nowhere to go for Courtney Reese. That was Chris Eaton meeting him at the line. 6'4", senior defensive end out of Queens, New York. Missed most of last year. That's just his third tackle of his collegiate career. Third down and 10. The ball in the 26. Bryant's going to go with one safety deep. Plenty of room on the boundaries for Brumfield to work with.
As he gives to Reese. Reese inside the red zone. Looked like he slipped as soon as he crossed the 20. It was Dante Lunin who was there to meet him.
Good initial move. Check that field. Is that water dripping on the 20? I'm kidding. He slipped. It's actually dripping, or was, down at the 10-yard line.
So UNLV sending the kicking unit out. Walker Harden to snap. The punter, Marshall Nichols, on the hold. Jose Pisano, 37. Snap, hold, boot. It's up, it's good. And the Rebels extend their lead to 27-0. The drive ends in points. The lead's extended. And the Rebels rolling in week one.
Conditioning makes quality service our top priority, and that's why Sierra was voted best air conditioning company in Las Vegas. Our highly trained technicians will make sure the job is done right the first time. Sierra Air is here to help you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We can help you with your air conditioning, water heater, UV lights, and water softeners. Call Sierra Air today for service that soars above the rest.
Take the road less traveled, we cross barriers, shift the narrative, and play by our rules. We don't fear the big moments. Take your shot. Cheer for each other. And always drive for change. Because when we go all in, we are unstoppable. Stop. You catching on?
Serving communities, citizens, and workers in Las Vegas since 1931, Las Vegas Power Professionals, IBEW, Local 357, and Southern Nevada NECA have provided tens of thousands of electrical industry careers for Southern Nevada families. To find out more about the Union Electrical Construction Industry, visit lvpowerpro.org.
UNLV on top of Bryant, 27-0.
Able to put 3 points on the board thanks to that interception by Thomas Anderson. Got the Rebels the ball back, and then it was all on the ground. A couple of great runs by Jacob DeJesus and Jet Thomas, setting up the Jose Pizano 37-yard field goal. And we've seen a lot of different names and numbers out there, Steve, but the production top to bottom has been rock solid for UNLV overall.
A very workmanlike drive, lots of damage on the ground, yards being gained by guys who are 5'8", 5'7", I'll say 5'6", so hooray for the short man. That's coming from me.
Andre Miono boots it, and in the end zone, taking the knee is Anthony Frederick. Want to go back to Jet Thomas, because that was a name as a true freshman that we had saw buried on the depth chart at the beginning of fall camp, but throughout fall camp and the first couple of weeks of practice, all of a sudden we heard more players and then more coaches and then more media
talking about the freshman out of Atlanta.
Yeah, he's a burner, and you know, hence the name Jet. And watching some of the practices, you could see he wanted to make an impact early. I was at a practice one day, and they were doing a drill where you're running towards the sideline and someone's standing there with a pad and you have to get physical. Is the defender going to
create the contact, or are you going to bring the contact to him? And Cornell Ford was yelling to create contact, and I saw Jet Thomas go and bowl over the coach who was holding the pad.
So who's the freshman who were the most enthusiastic in the hitting drills, right?
Well, that's how you're going to open eyes, right? When you've got veteran running backs, and you know, they brought in Donovan Lester and Vincent Davis for a reason. It was going to be an uphill climb for the freshman DJ Jones and Jet Thomas to get time. And Jet Thomas clearly has at times blown away the coaching staff. We had heard about the second scrimmage where he had busted off a big touchdown run. So he impressed people. And so far, I think he's looked great. You know, 6 carries for 47 yards, very explosive and very shifty.
27-point lead for the Rebels. Second down and 4 for Zevi Eckhaus. The Bryant Bulldogs, quarterback firing to the far side, gets it to Ruggieri, diving for extra yardage, and he was down at the 38-yard line. Fred Tompkins, the nearest defender to him. For Ruggieri, that's his 9th catch of the game.
Did you say he was a walk-on?
He was a former walk-on. Spoke with Bryant head coach Chris Merritt before the game. Merritt, a former walk-on and eventual 4-year letterman himself as a linebacker at Indiana. I asked him, I said, is there any walk-on stories like yours? And he pointed at Landon Ruggieri about 5 feet away.
He said, that guy right there. Said he put a target on his back in the offseason to see how he responded in drills and practices. And he said he responded better than anybody. Responding well there as he makes that shoestring catch around Anderson. You can see why this Bryant coaching staff loves the senior Landon Ruggieri.
I wonder how he was overlooked. He's not a small guy. No, 6 foot, 6'1", 195. Good hands there, good power. He's been impressive.
School record 56 catches last year. That's his 10th of the game already. Eckhaus looking for a running back, and he is crushed. Oh, what a hit as Simi Bakar took an absolute smothering blow from B.J. Harris.
Good to see B.J. out there, one of the challengers for the starting cornerback job. And just went down on the sideline, so I don't know if he got a cramp late there or what happened. He made the tackle, was getting substituted, and then fell down about a yard
from the sideline. By the way, Eckhaus did not do his running backs any favor on that play. I know he was trying to save the play and get rid of the ball, but awful position for the running back to be caught in as he couldn't see the defender.
Harris down, being tended to by the coaching staff. Head trainer Nate
Lauer out looking at the UNLV cornerback.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet, like the Pilot and Passport Trailsman and the Ridgeline, built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Confronting drought, drop by drop, harnessing the sun at the atomic level.
partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce, improving public health, combating poverty, uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, Rebels make it happen.
Wasn't feeling well. They sent him to a cardiologist, and the cardiologist could find nothing wrong even after all the tests. That really wasn't satisfactory. So he went to Preventive Diagnostic Center and had the body scan done. They found blockage in his arteries to his heart, and he needed to have stents put in. That saved his life.
I know we did the right thing by coming here, and I feel a lot better now. Everybody needs this done.
I can't imagine life without him.
B.J. Harris helped off the field.
After making a big tackle on an incomplete pass, Harris down near the UNLV sideline. Able to get back up under his own pressure. Get to by the training staff. Second down and 10 for Sebby Eckhouse. It's Bryant offense outgaining UNLV. 261 to 257 at this point, but a 27-point deficit. No points to show for it as of now. There's a running back, Simi Bakar, up next to him in motion. The give is to Bakar, across the 30. Tackled in midair by Jonathan Baldwin. As the safety out of Houston, Texas, upends the running back out of Austin, Texas. So it's a first down for Bryant. Physical tackler coming up from his strong safety position is Jonathan Baldwin. That's another guy that they use in a lot of different roles, even though the strong safety role pretty well defined in a lot of other programs. Split back in coverage here. Just over 5 minutes to play in the third quarter of the opening game of the 2023 campaign. Far so good for Barry Odom and company in the first game at the helm. It's Bakar once again. Gets around a tackler on the far sideline. He's flushed out of bounds by Baldwin once more. Back-to-back carries for Bakari. Back-to-back tackles, if you will, for Baldwin.
He's a good get. Fresno couldn't have used him. I know he's a grad transfer. By the way, Fresno today pulling the very mild upset against Purdue. And, you know, I reference Fresno a lot
with the way they've built this offense, Matt, where you've got guys who are 5'7 to 5'9 at wide receiver. And, you know, people scoff at that. Look at what Fresno's done over the years with small receivers. And Eric Brooks, who's 5'7, 171 at 170 yards receiving today.
House gives to McKendie. Brees McKendie fighting through a couple of tacklers. Brought down near the goal line. They're going to spot him at the half-yard line. Marcel McDuffie eventually wrestling him to the turf.
I'm guessing even up 27-0 that Barry Odom and Michael Shear are seething right now. Not a whole lot of pressure on Eckhouse when he drops back to pass. That time the O-line opened a gaping hole.
Bring in the heavy package, including running back Ryan Clark. Closest that Bryant has been to pay dirt. The give is to Clark, and he's in. Bryant with their first points of the 2023 campaign. Not a long, sustained drive.
And ending on the one-yard touchdown run from Ryan Clark. He had nine of them a year ago to lead all Bulldog running backs and gets on the board to start this season.
Big fella dropping the head, just got far enough. Forward progress. Ran through the tackle of Jonathan Baldwin, and they are on the scoreboard.
Bryant, thanks to 300 yards of total offense, finally on the board. They've rushed for 162 and passed for 138 more. Rebels have done a good job of, at least prior to this drive, stopping them on third and fourth downs and creating the turnovers, but eventually too much was too much, and Bryant on the board. Left-footed kick from the All-American Ethan Getman. He's up and in. The Rebel lead trimmed to 20. What kind of a response can we look for here from the Rebel offense?
Got to finish off a drive coming up, get another touchdown on the board. I assume there could be a deep shot coming up, but the run game has worked. Try to maintain possession, give the defense a little bit of a rest, and we'll see what they do on defense, if they're going to start attacking a little more. They rotate in some twos a little more to keep everyone fresh, although on some of the big runs there, you had the
second line guys playing on the defensive line, so Bryant made some good halftime adjustments. They're rolling right now, and this is not a complete surprise. They only have 7 points on the board, but we thought coming in they were going to move the ball, even against this 3-3-5 defense they did last year, right?
They were a really good offensive team a year ago. They just happened to lose a lot of close games. It went very much down to the wire to finish 4-7, but you knew coming back with 10 of 11 starters on offense, they could move the ball.
Yeah, last year, 7 of Bryant's 11 games were decided by one possession. They ended up 2-5 in those one possession games, so they very easily could have won at least 6 games last year if one or two bounces goes a different way for them.
See what they do here on the kickoff.
Faking some trickery, and now we'll go back into a more traditional kickoff alignment.
Faked out on that. Thought something was happening. Maybe it still will.
I just want something to happen.
I like chaos.
Lester and DeJesus back. A low spiraling kick that's fielded by DeJesus on the near side. Out of the 2, he'll go to the far side. He's got some space. Jacob DeJesus, only the kicker to beat. He's around him. One man creeping up behind him is DeJesus near the goal line. He's tripped up at the 2, but what a return from Jacob DeJesus.
A touchdown saving tackle by Lake Ellis.
97 yards, and look at the moves here. We should give credit too, though. That was great blocking in the middle of the field, and now it's a race to the end zone.
Good hustle and ankle tackle.
Lake Ellis, the defender that tripped him up, Florida State champion, the 4x100 relay in high school.
That was a good matchup.
That's all it takes to bring down Jacob DeJesus on a touchdown saving tackle. If there's anybody on the Bryant roster that was going to track him down, it was Lake Ellis, and he was just able to do so. 96 yards on the return. Donovan Lester with a touchdown, a 2-yard run. Asked you about the response. I don't think it could get any quicker than that.
I did not predict that. That was a hell of a return by DeJesus. And as I've said throughout the game, he is their X factor. Whether it's in the run game, whether it's in the pass game on those jet sweeps, and then you see Donovan Lester here. Awesome blocking in the middle. Jordan Humphrey, one of the power backs in there. And then Lester just about untouched into the end zone. That was a good answer.
8 touchdowns in William and Mary last year for Donovan Lester. That's where he's at his best,
using that 6'2", 215-pound frame to power through opposing defensive linemen and hold-and-go situations. Pisano's extra point is up and through. And almost as quickly as the lead was cut, was extended, now on top 34-7. Talk about the 3
phases of the game, offense, defense, and the forgotten one, special teams. The Rebels have absolutely won the special team battle so far today.
And that's 5 or 6 chunk plays if you include special teams. And this is what they wanted to do with this offense. They haven't been able to push the ball down the field with deep shots, but in the run game, they've gotten big results. And I'll keep saying it. They added a lot of little guys with a lot of speed, and DeJesus there. That was awesome. And here's the other thing. We're going to have a discussion about this a lot. If you go out to UNLV practice, while a lot of schools around the country have said, yeah, you know, with the new rules, special teams, we need to work on it. James Shebest gets a lot of time to have his units out there and a lot of participation from, you know, major players on the team. They work on special teams a lot. They want dividends out of this thing. And so far, to Matt's point, they've gotten it.
Really interesting to see Barry Odom letting his position coaches really run the majority of
practice as well. One thing that Coach Odom has done already is develop assistant coaches. On kickoff, inside the 10 by Frederick. He's stuffed immediately. Gain of 11 yards and a couple of Bryant Bulldogs down after the Rashad Tanner tackle.
Tanner, another one of those guys who's starting to emerge as a star on special teams. Had a big stop on the last special teams return set. You know, we never got to talk about Barry Odom now as a guy who's in his second stint as a head coach. And one of the things I have been impressed with, and I think it does happen with first-time head coaches, maybe they don't delegate enough. Maybe they feel like they got to have their fingerprints all over every aspect of the game. Well, he went out and got a veteran in James Shebess, who he thinks is one of the top five special teams coaches in the country for a reason.
Along with Brendan Marion, a lot to be excited about with these position coaches. How about that tackle in the backfield? Sidney Bakar ripped up by Jare Williams. He has been in the Bulldog backfield all afternoon.
Yeah, Darius Johnson, a little deceiving. Number eight playing DT, 6'3", 300 pounds. Was a big guy last year. He's really kind of got shredded up. Good speed, was the ball of muscle. He was back there.
As you mentioned, Shelton was back there as well. But to build on that point of delegation, you've seen it at practice and you mentioned it. You've got young coordinators. They're allowed to do what they want and prep their guys. I love the delegation by a veteran coach in Barry Odom.
Fisher came back into the game for the first time at defensive end. Throws right over his head, and how about that tight window? Slipped in there to Landon Ruggieri. A great throw before Elad was able to rip him down. Call that trust. You want to call that between Eckhouse and Ruggieri. That's his guy. No window whatsoever, but he found some space. And now with third down and nine upcoming, Eckhouse on the offense looking to the sideline for a play. 10th third down opportunity for the Bulldogs on the day. They've gotten it twice. Ooh. Eckhouse hit as he throws it short. And that'll bring up a fourth down and nine.
Oh, Lord. Who got just trucked on the left side of the line for Bryant? Just a power move, a defensive pancake.
It's Elijah Shelton bringing down left tackle Jeff Woods. Gotta be pretty big to throw a 6'6", 293 pounder to the turf.
The Norfolk State transfer in Jeff Woods obliterated, and Eckhouse really with no time to throw whatsoever. So this likely an opportunity here as Jimmy O'Brien, the second punter on the roster, to boot it away to Jacob DeJesus with the big kickoff return.
Bryant with a low kick, bouncing at the Rebel 45 and taking a Bryant spin, touched up at the 40-yard line. So the Rebels will take over after it's picked up by Ryan Clark. For UNLV, really no sustained drives outside of that one field goal drive early on in the third quarter. They've done it with the big plays set up by the special team. So now we'll see an opportunity for Doug Brumfield to lead what could be one last big, long scoring drive.
When's the last time you saw a team on the wrong side of a 34-7 score and their time of possession is 27 minutes to 14?
Outgaining UNLV. Held the ball longer, but the Rebels have taken way more advantage of their opportunities to this point. Fake to Thomas. Brumfield. Firing deep, he's got DeJesus. He overthrows his man. Penalty in the backfield as Brumfield was obliterated.
And pressure certainly influencing the throw there. Let's watch the replay and see if it did. Again, a little too much of a laser on the throw. A little more air underneath it.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Number three on the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic first down.
That's a big penalty committed by 6'1" senior out of Jersey City, New Jersey, Ben Silver. That was a great design, well diagrammed play, but the execution just not there on the touch.
But again, glass overflowing. Jacob DeJesus was wide open by 8 yards. So again, speaking to his danger as a receiver and a route runner and his speed. My Lord.
Flags flying everywhere.
The right side of UNLV line jump there.
I'll wait the call.
Looks like it.
False start. 65 on the offense. 5 yards. Still first down.
So that's on the center, Jack Hawes, who is expected to be a pivotal part of this offensive line group, the Buffalo transfer.
For the false start. The Rebels give back 5 yards. Hawes to snap it from the Bryant 44. Brumfield rolling again. Fires a laser beam to Ricky White. He's got it. He's out of bounds. Down at the 37-yard line. Good throw on the move by Doug.
One area where we talked to Brendan Marion in the offseason was about game planning with a left-handed quarterback. He said they flipped a lot of the plays, but then we talked to Doug Brumfield a week later. He said he doesn't need to do that. We see a lot of rollouts to the left. And Brumfield looking left here. This one dropped by Thomas. Just a bit low. But again, a lot of the rollouts, the designed movement to the left side for Doug Brumfield, the southpaw.
Yeah, the funny thing is with Doug, I think the point he was making is I've always had to go the opposite way, so I'm so used to it, it doesn't make a big difference. But Brennan Marion said they did some self-analysis, self-grading, and they noticed that flipping the field is going to help Brumfield more.
Brumfield here on third down, keeps it himself, looking for a first. He's got it, and Moore delivering a blow as he goes out of bounds, running over the safety, Javis Rayside.
Great run, good speed, good power. I think Jeff Thomas had a big gain in front of him too, but
Maybe Doug, after the drop pass, was like, I'm going to do it myself. I'm going to go get a first down.
See on the replay there, he almost spun Thomas around, yanking it out of the gut. That's a big first down run for Doug Brumfield. Looks like he's going to keep it again. Fires the pass. That's to the tight end, Shelton.
He on the third, as he's down at the 20, gets him inside in the energy red zone once more.
Kind of an interesting play, huh? Multiple options. Doug looked like if he had fallen forward, he would have gotten a couple of yards. Get Shelton involved a little bit. I know their goal is to get Shelton down the field more in the middle of the field. He could be a capable receiver.
Brandon Marion told us they're planning on using the tight ends more this year than in years past in this offense. Brumfield with the pump fake. He'll tuck it and run it himself. Gets it inside the 10 before he's upended. Another big run for Brumfield. That one for a first down. Doug up over 40 yards on the ground today.
He's a good runner. He's elusive. He's fast. Has pretty good power even at 217.
First down and goal to go from the 8-yard line. Here's Jet Thomas. Around a couple of tacklers. And the freshman in for the second time today. That's another Rebel score. How about the collegiate debut for the 5'9
freshman out of Atlanta, Jet Thomas.
You are not going to arm tackle around the thigh of Jet Thomas. Not only fast, but shows the good power as he turns out here. Yep, set the tackler. Brian Blair kind of rolls all the way down his body, and this is a great debut.
Man, I thought they were going to have some good weapons in Vincent Davis and Lester. And as Matt said earlier, about a week into fall camp, you're like, okay, the freshman running backs might get, a look later in the season. This guy could be a key player.
Extra point up and good. Lead now 41-7. After the fifth rushing touchdown of the game for the Rebels. We knew the run game was going to be a pivotal part of this offense. They have dominated, and again, with all five guys all really getting in. Thomas, along with Reese, Vincent Davis, and the Senator Donovan Lester, who was expected to take a heap of the carries.
And I'm not saying this game is over, but it's getting close. This is exactly what you want with Michigan on the horizon. You want to get all your starters and lots of your twos time. You want to have a safe gap, and then in the fourth quarter, get some more backups in there, make sure no one gets needlessly hurt, because next week is going to be incredibly
physical against one of the best teams in the country. So I'm looking forward to this fourth quarter. We'll see who's showcased out there. We'll see if Jaden Maiava gets some time. I think he should get him on the field. So we'll see how they play it with the coaching staff.
You mentioned next week the Rebels potentially looking ahead to a matchup at the Big House against number 2 ranked Michigan.
Number 2 ranked team in the country, tied for the highest ranked team the UNLV has ever played. That was with a unique schedule this year as well. They'll welcome their first ever SEC opponent to Las Vegas the week following as Vanderbilt comes to Allegiant Stadium. Frederick to field it for Bryant at the 3-yard line. He'll try to take it to the far side.
Yeah.
Knocked down once again inside the 15. The Rebels have kept Anthony Frederick bottled up. Nobody in the country could do that last year.
Their coverage has been great against a great return man. I almost got nabbed by the double number situation. It's like 17, Dominic. Nope. Chris Williams. There are more than a few double numbers or shared numbers. Chris Williams is a nice player. He brought him in from Limestone College. Correct, I've never heard of it before either, but he's turned out to be a pretty valuable guy on
special teams. We'll see what Bryant can dial up here. And I am being told by Tony Cordasco.
Offsides, number 37 in the kicking team. 5 yards from the previous spot. Re-kick.
So a mistake there. I am being told by
Tony that Jaden Maiava, the backup quarterback, is indeed warming up for the Rebels, so we'll see if he comes into the game when they do get the ball back in the fourth quarter. We'll get another return on tap here.
Jaden Maiava, true freshman out of Liberty.
Redshirt.
Likely going to see him.
Yeah, redshirt.
He was here last year. They really liked what they saw. We'll get into him. The Rebels get the ball back eventually, but yeah, looks like they're going to re-kick here.
Advantage Bryant, right?
At least in the small sample size.
Well, UNLV just ran down the field. We'll see if Andre Miano can help out his guys who might be a little bit gassed and boot it into the end zone or through the back of the end zone. What does Frederick have on the day in terms of... you're much better at reading stats than I am. These newfangled stat pages. What's his average on a return?
Four returns, 71 yards, 17.8 yards per return.
Okay. Look at his numbers last year. He averaged 30 yards per return.
I knew I was onto something.
901 yards of kick returns last year was the most at any level of collegiate football. UNLV to, at least so far, limit him to just about half of his average last year.
Gotta be excited, but another opportunity with 5 yards extra of space. Miano boots it. This one a little bit further than the last one.
Yeah.
Man, he fair catches it in the end zone. That's how you rectify the offsides error.
Maybe Frederick was tired. I had it wrong.
With 4 seconds to go in the third quarter, Bryant will have one play for quarter number four. And they're scoring on their most recent drive for the first time today. Bryant, who, by the way, is still outgaining UNLV and has held the ball for nearly double the time. The Rebels have done a great job of spreading out the damage. Barry Odom looking for a win in his first game at the helm of the UNLV program. Odom, in 4 years at Missouri as the head coach, was 2-2 in openers. And the Eckhouse in the final play of the third dumps it down underneath. That's Connor Lathrop, the tight end.
Down inside the 30, down at the 31. That'll do it for quarter number three. Fourth quarter coming up from Allegiant Stadium. It's been all UNLV in the opening game.
Psst. There's something special going on at UNLV.
Here's the first customer that bought a car.
The Avondros, that's the first date.
First one out.
No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota has led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We've made the best memories and lasting friendships from the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
We know our Vegas traffic is tough. We've been here for more than 30 years. We see it and you see it.
Yeah, there's congestion, construction, and distractions everywhere.
And that leads to accidents. People get hurt.
An injury could put your future at stake. That's why we fight so hard for each and every client.
And that's why we make sure every detail of every case is done right. Every I is dotted and every T is crossed.
So we get you the money you deserve.
Hennison Haight. Help is here.
Psst. There's something special going on at UNLV.
Make this the year you take charge of your health by getting a scan that can detect serious illnesses like heart disease, cancer, and more. And it's only available in Las Vegas at Preventative Diagnostic Center.
I'm Dr. John Pierce. These scans give you a clear picture of your body that you've never had access to before. Now you can have peace of mind and take a proactive approach before you have any signs or symptoms of a serious health concern. This scan saves lives.
Get a heart scan with calcium scoring for just $125. Call Preventative Diagnostic Center now, 702-534-7900.
On sale now. The Grey Day Tour 2023, featuring Suicide Boys, Ghost Mane, and more. October 7th at the Thomas and Mack Center. Runnin' Rebel Basketball is back in the Mack. Season tickets are on sale now. UNLV Lady Rebels, tickets starting at $6.
Tickets on sale now at UNLVtickets.com or 702-739-FANS.
UNLV, the fans, we get you there.
UNLV football presented by Finley
Toyota entering into the fourth quarter. It's UNLV leading Bryant 41-7 in the week one matchup. Rebels using offense, defense, and as we see here, special teams en route to a dominant performance through three quarters. Return there by Jacob DeJesus, setting up that two-yard touchdown run by Donovan Lester. And with Bryant taking the ball to start, here's Zevi Eckhouse in the first play of the fourth. The give is up the middle, second down and four. Now third down and two. UNLV gang tackling in the middle as they have been all afternoon. Did a good job of filling in the gaps, especially Jackson Woodard, who made the tackle there.
And now you see Naki Fahina, number six, 300-pound senior, defensive tackle, getting some of his first action of the day. We can talk about Naki a little more in terms of his comeback story. Osei Abase is out there at defensive end, the kid who came in at about 215. Now he's a solid 255.
You said it. This is the kind of game every coach wants in week one, just in terms of
the dominance and being able to get in your second and third stringers. Osei Abase, 6'4", 250-pound junior out of Encino, California. Southern California native Zevi Eckhouse. Complete over the middle, but a flag in the backfield.
This is number one target, Landon Ruggieri, across the line of game, but this one likely coming back. And Ray, the referee, with the call.
Holding, number 75 on the offense. 10 yards, still third down.
Trevor Smith called for the hold. It was Xavier Carter drawing it. I think that's one of the areas where he can be so special, is forcing mistakes from exterior linemen. Speed, a killer for the LSU transfer, Xavier Carter. He had an interesting route to Las Vegas from Baton Rouge. Dom Fertitta, graduate assistant at LSU after spending 4 years as a player at Notre Dame, former Bishop Gorman Gale, came to work under Barry Odom and said to Xavier Carter, hey, you should come with me. And here we are. Eckhouse gets around a trio of defenders.
Airs it up for a wide open receiver. It's Matthew Prochaska. One man to beat. Prochaska cuts it underneath, stays on the feet. And he's eventually tripped up, brought down at the one.
Well, clutch replay. See what got busted here.
Good pitch and catch.
Good job by Eckhouse to evade the pressure as well.
He's wide open.
Jet Elad burned in coverage. A 76-yard pitch and catch from Eckhouse to Prochaska, senior out of Danville, California. Ryan Clark, the goal line back, goes to Eckhouse's right. First goal from the 1.5-yard line. Eckhouse pulls it out of the gut. Eckhouse to the corner. Eckhouse looking end zone. They're going to spot him shy. They say he's out of bounds at the 1-inch line. Cameron Oliver setting the edge and getting credit for the tackle. This one where Eckhouse just tried to read the defense and find a gap. It never was there. Oliver did a great job to shimmy him out of bounds with the forearm.
Landon Ruggieri checks in. A lot of bodies on the left side of the line here for Bryant. Under 10 to go on the play clock as the formation shifts right.
Clark's got it. Leaping and scoring. Bryant into the end zone for the second time this afternoon. Ryan Clark with the rushing touchdown. Cuts the deficit for UNLV. That's his second touch, second score. He's in there for one purpose and one purpose only. That's to move the pile at the goal line.
You don't want Bryant to light you up here in the fourth quarter, but this quick drive can provide plenty of learning moments for the defense.
Kyle Forsley to snap, Jimmy O'Brien to hold, and Ethan Getman's kick is up and splitting the uprights. Bryant scores for the second time in the second half. UNLV takes over for their first drive of the fourth quarter on top big in week one.
Set summer in motion with the most adventurous Honda vehicles yet.
Like the Pilot and Passport Trailsman and the Ridgeline. Built for better off-road performance and engineered for more adventure. This summer, create your own adventures with Honda, the most awarded brand in Car and Driver 10 Best history. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
Here's the first customer that bought a car.
The Avondros, that's the first date.
First one.
No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota's led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We've made the best memories and lasting friendships from the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
UNLV football brought to you by Star Nursery, your garden's partner for every blooming thing. Bryant able to score for the second time in the second half to cut it to 41-14. It was all set up by the 76-yard pitch and catch from Eckhouse to Matthew Prochaska. The Rebels couldn't make the goal line stand. Bryant starting to get some offensive rhythm here in half number two.
Matt, I love working with you up here in this TV role. These are the moments where I miss on the sidelines, because I would love to see what's going on in terms of
the discussions with the defense after that drive and that sort of blown coverage.
It's a short kick. Jet Thomas runs up to grab it at the 24. Thomas across the 40. It's a couple of jukes to the inside. He's brought down about the 43, but there is a penalty coming in from behind the play. The flag resting at the 32. Typically in the area of holding, but we'll await the call.
There are fouls on both teams. Offsides, number 19 on the kicking team. Holding, number 8. On the receiving team, those penalties offset, will re-kick.
Well, you see the results of early season, a little sloppy. I think that's between the two teams, that's the second offsides on the kicking team.
One for each side.
Ken Ray, the official. A little bit gassed. It's fourth quarter. You know, we all have gas tank issues in the first time out.
So we'll get a re-kick. I got to tell you, watching Jet Thomas, though, when you watch him, it is just... he's going straight forward. All of a sudden, he just smoothly slide sideways. You're like, I don't know how he's doing this, but he got another 10 yards out of it. He is, man, between both of these guys, we're going to have some big plays from the special teams unit with DeJesus and
Jaden Thomas back on these kicks.
For an 18-year-old true freshman, he shows such patience with the ball in his hand. A lot of times, especially in your collegiate debut, you just want to get the ball and do a little bit of everything. But Thomas... again, showing great patience every time he's touched it so far. The ball spotted at the 35. Bryant, who's been faking that kickoff look all day, will now use the left boot of Ethan Getman to get it underway. So we'll try that one again after offsetting penalties.
Going deep this time.
DeJesus from the 1. DeJesus gets around the defender, cuts it inside. Jacob DeJesus inside across the 40. Runs into his own man before being brought down. But that's a return of 40 yards with a late flag coming in from the Bryant sideline. Another outstanding return from Jacob DeJesus. You want to talk about a guy who's
comfortable with the ball in his hands.
That's too bad if UNLV gets flagged on this. You'll remember the last 2 years, the return game, there just wasn't much coming out of it. I think it was more about safety, just taking care of the ball.
During the return, personal foul, blindside block, number 9, 15 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
As we look at the replay there, there was some contact in the back, Jet Elad coming in behind the play. Blindside block, one of the points of emphasis.
Correction, the foul was officials. On number 8.
We're going to change it. Bo Edmondson or rather Timothy Flash Connerly called for the foul. Regardless of who the foul is on, UNLV's going to take over at the 22, and who's behind center? It's Jaden Maiava, redshirt freshman out of Liberty High School, highest-rated quarterback in UNLV recruiting history. He flips it outside on the first play from scrimmage. Jet Thomas trying to garner a couple of extra yards and flushed out of bounds by a trio of Bryant defenders. So a redshirt freshman and a true freshman in the backfield. Already like what's gone on with the recruiting.
I was going to say, interesting to see Maiava, who does have a good arm and is 230 pounds, go on the move. He's actually a very mobile guy for his size.
6'4" right-hander with his first completion. And it is to Thomas. Look at him cut inside.
Now back out, dragging a defender with him. And Jeff Thomas down on the field. Oh, no. Thomas down, grabbing his leg, but Jaden Maiava, the first completion of the year. See if we can spot it here as the ankle was wrapped up. He was brought down hard and kind of awkwardly by Nicholas Alvarado.
Little MMA ankle lock there, a little twist at the end.
Alvarado.
Looks like it. Hopefully he gets up quickly.
Northern Illinois transfer wrapping up the true freshman. Thomas down as he's being tended to on the field. 11:32 to go in the contest. So step aside for the injury timeout.
At Intermountain Healthcare, you get quality care from Nevada caregivers you know and trust. But you also get more. More technology options to simplify and improve your care experience. More nationally renowned specialists to serve you. More comprehensive care, including preventive care and mental health support. What does getting more mean? A healthier, stronger you. And healthier, stronger communities. Because all of us are better together.
My husband wasn't feeling well. They sent him to a cardiologist, and the cardiologist could find nothing wrong even after all the tests. That really wasn't satisfactory. So he went to Preventive Diagnostic Center and had the body scan done. They found blockage in his arteries to his heart, and he needed to have stents put in. That saved his life.
I know we did the right thing by coming here, and I feel a lot better now. Everybody needs this done.
I can't imagine life without him.
Here's the first customer that bought a car.
The Avondros, that's the first date.
First one.
No furniture in the building.
Over the last 25 years, Finley Toyota has led the city in new and used car sales. We've had the most victories, the most sponsorships, and we believe the happiest customers. We've made the best memories and lasting friendships. From the bottom of our hearts.
We love you, Las Vegas!
It's our 25th anniversary. Come in and see what makes Finley Toyota so special.
UNLV football presented by Finley Toyota. Jet Thomas able to run off the field under his own power as both teams break the huddle now. UNLV leads Bryant 41-14. 11:32 to play in the opening day game. And Gary Odom has to be pleased with his players. Top to bottom, everybody getting in, and a lot of different guys making an impact at all three phases of the game. Jaden Maiava, your freshman out of Las Vegas. And up the middle, that's Vincent Davis. Davis bringing a couple of defenders with him. Tackled inside the 45, spotted down at the 43-yard line.
Good run. Alani, big Alani, the
left guard, down. He's been with the program a long time. He's actually going back. He's actually a Tony Sanchez commit, believe it or not. All right. 6'3", 260. I mean, one of the biggest human beings I've ever seen. His legs are just massive. And
a couple years ago, I remember talking to veteran guard Julio Garcia, and I said to him, it was off the record at the time, but I'm putting it on the record now. I said, hey, who's the next guy? Like, who's the good prospect of all the big guys? And he said, Alani. He's like, we've had you know, NFL players come in here, camps come in here, you know, offense against defensive line, and he said he holds his own against pretty much everyone. He's not going to get out muscled, and he just said he's got to do the right things off the field. So he gets up a little bit ginger here, but he's got a bright future, and he certainly has the frame. At, like I said, 6'3 and 260 pounds. He's limping a bit, starting to loosen up a little bit.
Lonnie Makaheli, the 6'3, 350-pounder out of Anchorage, Alaska.
Gave him 360, I'm sorry.
Hey, he might as well be 360. I'm sure he's 360 in pads. It is backup, at least on the depth chart, true freshman Austin Boyd wearing number 79.
We'll see if he comes in. Matthias
Sua, I think Boyd is in there. Matthias Sua, who's a Bishop Gorman kid, came back from Western Colorado. You see him out there. He's number 78. He's a 320-pounder, but I think Boyd is out there.
Ayaba under center and swallowed up immediately is Courtney Reese.
Nowhere to go for the senior out of Florida. It was Maximus Villar smothering him in the backfield. Sets up a third down and 6 for Ayaba. Ayaba, second team All-Nevada as a senior in high school, turned down offers from both Auburn and Tennessee to come to UNLV.
That play kind of got off to a rough start. From the get-go, Maiava had a little trouble handling the snap, so the timing was thrown off.
He's got an opportunity here on what's called a third down and 5. Everybody to the left except for the receiver to the near side. That's where they go. It's caught by Connerly as he's across the first down line to gain. They'll give him a first down with the clock rolling. Here with new rules in college football. Clock won't stop after a first down until in 2 minutes of the second and fourth quarters. He's no longer allowed to call consecutive timeouts as well. Those are the two main ones.
So that's a big first down conversion. Rebels with just about 10 minutes to go in the game, looking to run some serious clock down on this drive. Ayaba fakes the pitch to Connerly and takes it himself. He's across the 50 into Bryant territory. Knocked out at the
Bulldog 49-yard line. Ayaba showing off the wheels a bit.
He's a good runner. He's got good instincts. He's aggressive. You know, one of the reasons I love covering college football is the, we'll call it the circuitous journeys guys take to certain teams. And, you know, Connerly getting a catch there. He's got a great story from Louisiana, made his way to Fresno City College.
First touch of the game for Jordan Young-Humphrey. And he stopped almost immediately. Humphrey, Stetson transfer, tackled by Dante Lunan.
Sorry to cut you off. Another dude, you know, from Northern Florida. Walked on with Arroyo's squad last year. When I was talking to Arroyo then, he didn't have a whole lot of information on Jordan Young-Humphrey. Like, hey, he impressed us. He's on the team, and he's carved out a little bit of a role. One more thing on Connerly. So he's from Louisiana, goes to Fresno, was a high-level JUCO sprinter, and again, to speak to the point of just trying to find speed all over the field. And
hopefully guys can develop their receiving skills and break big plays.
Dominic Jacinto by himself at the top of the screen. The give is to him. Jacinto with his first catch. And he's got some space to the outside. Just knocked out of bounds. Jacinto nearly broke it for the score.
Missouri, New Mexico State. Now Jacinto brought in late to the program. They like him too.
And it was originally recruited by Barry Odom when he was the head coach at Missouri. So playing for him in his second stint underneath Barry. It's Courtney Reese making a man miss, brought down to the 29-yard line. The running game starting to take over here late. Davis Rayside coming up from the strong safety spot to bring him down.
Be nice to get Courtney a big run or two, get him in the end zone. You know, we mentioned had a breakout game last year when Robbins was not available against Notre Dame.
Flags everywhere. Looks like a false start. UNLV here on second down.
False start, 65 offense, 5 yards, still second down.
That's on the center, Jack Hawes,
once more. I don't know the last time I've seen a center call for a false start twice in one game.
How is that even possible? If he goes first, everyone follows. Maybe a little shakage of the ball.
Yeah, it's about the only way a center can be called. Into the game for the first time here is Christian Earls, and they really like this 6'8"
tight end out of Chandler, Arizona. Maiava with a pump fake, airs one out deep. Nearly a diving catch for Connerly. That one just too far inside, and a penalty after the play. How about that? Looks like some jawing That's the one thing we've seen today. Both teams have been disciplined in terms of the chippiness back and forth, but late in a 41-14 game, starting to see some competitiveness come out of these guys. We'll see who the infraction was on. It was well behind the play. Flagged by the original line of scrimmage.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. Number 90 on the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down. That's the first unsportsmanlike penalty for number 90 that goes towards ejection.
Hollis Durstein,
sophomore out of Acton, Massachusetts, who didn't play last year. Didn't have to travel too far to get to Bryant. Located in Smithfield, Rhode Island, just outside of Providence. So that sets up UNLV with a first down. Just inside the NV Energy red zone at the 20. Mayava gives up the middle.
Looking for something, but getting nothing is Courtney Reese. He's knocked down immediately by Maximus Villar, who played for head coach Chris Merritt at Christopher Columbus High School, where Merritt made a name for himself as one of the top high school coaches in Florida for 18 years. He's got a couple of guys from Christopher Columbus High. Columbus and St. Thomas Aquinas, the two powerhouses out of Miami. A gain of one. Alba gives to Reese again, and he's knocked over immediately for no gain.
Was that the turf monster, or did he and Mayava get caught up a little bit?
The break in the roof was on the other side in the first half. Do want to say as well, get your thoughts on the throwback sticker on the helmets. I'm a huge fan.
I like it. I think they should use the alternate helmets more often.
Rebels going with the scarlet red tops in the opening week game.
Mayava rolling right, looking for the end zone. He flips it up. It was intended for D'Angelo Urban. With nobody around, that one falling harmlessly out of bounds. And now on fourth down, here comes the kicking team. They'll look to add three onto their lead.
Well, this is the kind of drive you want for Jaden Mayava. Get him some different looks. Get him involved in the running game as well, but like a little bit better execution on third down there at the end. Here's Jose Pisano, second team All-American 2 years ago at Missouri. This one's up from 35. It's right down the middle to extend the lead, 43-14. Rebels using some more special teams prowess to extend the advantage there. First drive for Jaden Mayava, the Scarlet and Gray. 6:39 to go here.
Rebels, attorney. Trust is so important.
Trust isn't given. It's earned.
You want someone that will be with you every step of the way. Someone you trust with your health and your future.
Someone with integrity and the experience to get you the settlement you deserve.
And we believe trust means putting our clients' interests first.
And that's what we do every day.
Hennison Haight. Help is here.
Confronting drought, drop by drop. Harnessing the sun at the atomic level.
Partnering to support entrepreneurship and build an unstoppable workforce. Improving public health. Combating poverty. Uplifting our entire community. That's the mission of the region's only top-tier research university. Every day, UNLV does work that makes life better around the world and here at home. UNLV, Rebels make it happen. Want to study the artifacts of Hollywood royalty? Or engineer the next entertainment spectacle? Would you like to solve a podcast-worthy mystery? It's not fiction. It's UNLV, where higher ed gets a Vegas twist. Diverse, evolving, just like you. Get your degree and some unconventional experiences for an education unlike any other. Rebels make it happen. Enroll at unlv.edu.
Las Vegas! Your world champion Las Vegas Aces are headed to T-Mobile Arena for the final regular season home game. Sunday, September 10th at noon. Let's pack T-Mobile Arena and send the Aces to the playoffs in style. Fan Appreciation Day, and you don't want to miss it. Tickets start at just $10. Great seats are still available. Visit LasVegasAces.com.
Rebels able to add on to their lead. What a field goal punched through by transfer Jose Pisano. And the special teams has been a flavor here in this opening week game. Typically, that's not something that a normal fan base is going to think about as a strength in week one. But in the early part of the season, the special teams even more important.
No doubt. And it's rare to see teams practice as much special teams as UNLV practices. But again, I said it earlier. Paying dividends.
It's paid off. Pisano's made all three of his field goal attempts as this one is returned to the 14-yard line. As we dig down into the depth chart, that's the first touch for Aiden White, the wide receiver. Kickoff return for anybody not named Anthony Frederick for the Bryant Bulldogs.
Even they're looking for their second string option in certain positions.
Their coverage on kickoffs has been outstanding. And, you know, it's funny, Shebest mentioned this a couple weeks ago. He said right now the NCAA does not track average starting position on drives, and it's a
massive stat because I know in the Mountain West Conference, and I'll continue on this.
Ridge Dosakall, the backup quarterback, checks in. Also the first time in the game for Isaiah Schmidtke, who's got the ball and pushing a couple of Rebel defenders, able to gain, we'll call it 3 yards, second down and seven upcoming.
Well, either Schmidtke went to the wrong side or the QB didn't know what side he was going to be on. Does that make sense? Because he had to turn both ways to make the handoff. So not the smoothest first play by some of the twos for Bryant. On the average starting position in the Mountain West Conference, I think two schools that have been really, really good with their kicking game, and especially the kicker being able to bury the ball and the coverage, has been consistently San Diego State and Nevada.
Toast to call the Idaho transfer. Airs one out of bounds. He was looking for a receiver right in front of the UNLV bench.
It was Javen Dames, Stuart Florida, the intended target.
And UNLV outside of Good to Boot, Daniel Gutierrez, making field goals, just had not been that good the last couple years with the return game and the coverage game, giving up some really big plays. Remember a couple years ago, they
should have beaten Utah State, who I believe that year went on to go 10-3, if not for Savon Scarver, a local, who took back a kick, and those are devastating plays.
Schmidtke with it up the middle, gets through the first level of defense, and took a nice play by Xavier Carter to prevent any further gain. Ridge Dosakall, a sophomore, a 6'4" transfer from Idaho, originally from Scottsdale, Arizona, three-star recruit out of Saguaro High School, also 4 out of 5 of the offensive line in the game right now for Bryant backups. The only starter, the left tackle, Jeff Woods. Chris Merritt, the Bryant head coach, able to get some tape on some players. It's the toughest game on the schedule. The third year in a row that Bryant has played an FBS opponent. Schmidtke again stopped for a short game. This is a Bryant team after tonight. We'll head back home to welcome in the Sharks of Long Island University next week
before they take on Brown in week 3. Their conference matchups start on October 14th. We talked at the onset of the broadcast about the Big South and the Ohio Valley Conference combining to form one 10-team super conference, with a lot of the alignment even affecting the FCS level.
Matt, some of the players just getting some playing time now on defense. I want you to give it a run here in a second. Let's see if he makes a tackle here first.
You looking for Fisher Kamak? That's who was in on the stop.
I was looking for number 53, a Hawaiian. Go ahead.
You're talking about Blessing Alualu Tuiolomotu.
Easy for you to say.
Freshman out of Hawaii.
They love him. I'm telling you. The players rave about him. He got a lot of playing time in the spring game. Like, naturally a big kid at linebacker. We'll call it big trunk. You know, the legs and the lower body.
Blessing 6'2", 235, and every bit of it. Kamak nearly stepped in the way of that pass, but the big defensive end at 6'7", able to get a hand on it. It's another guy who's going to be a disruptor in the future for this team.
He has a chance to be a really good player. He came in at about 235 pounds, 6'7".
He's every bit of 6'7". He's got one of those frames where he could probably get up to 270, 275, so really bright future for Fisher.
And they like him as a specialist as well. He is an edge rusher on the field goal block team and caused havoc during many a practice during
fall camp. So back to boot it away is Ethan Gettman. Look out for Jacob DeJesus, set to return. Rebels send everybody back in coverage. DeJesus calls for the fair catch, and he's got it at the UNLV 28. 3:49 to play in the game as the Rebels to wind down the clock, leading by 30 in their opening week matchup. Is there anything that's surprised you about this Rebel performance today here early on?
I think the chunk plays. I thought they'd have a pretty good running game, but, you know, you never know until you actually see the offensive line, which, you know, 60% new. And we pointed out Jalen St. John should be the starting left tackle, but it's been Anton Ambule most of the day. By the way, now Will Thomas, the third left tackle, a behemoth at 6'7", 320, another transfer. He's in there at left tackle.
Graham Keating, the third, also in at center. There's Jaden Maiava. Hands off up the middle.
That's Courtney Reese once more. Reese with his eighth touch of the game. You look at the Rebels in terms of spreading out the carries. Eight carries for Thomas, Lester, Reese. Brumfield's got seven as well. Four guys with eight carries.
Yeah, I thought this does not surprise me.
I figured most games you're not going to see a player get, unless they're really on fire, beyond like 13 carries.
Reese Humphrey. Now the Jordan Young Humphrey on the left side. Stopped after a gain of four. Sets up a third down and short.
And if I sound like I'm being critical of the last coaching staff, I like that group. I thought they did a pretty good job. But they rode Aiden Robbins hard. And the only problem with going with high volume with a lot of your players is the backup sometimes may not be ready. And I really thought that was a point of the spring and especially the fall with Barry Odom's staff, that they wanted to make sure if they have injuries that they're going to have good backups who have experience, look confident, which I'll talk about Maiava here in a second.
Maiava on third down. It's around the defender. Under pressure, complete over the middle to Earls. His first catch as a Rebel.
Gets him to midfield as the helmet goes flying. It's grabbed by the 6'8" sophomore tight end.
I mean, that's a good play right there. Right? Maiava has to be elusive. On the run here. Escapes the pressure. A good throw. And then, as you mentioned, the staff is really high on Christian Earls.
He is gigantic. 6'8" and 255 pounds. You know, real interesting character when we got to talk to him about a week ago.
Oh, yeah. I mean, between Earls and Ballengai and Zion, they really like this tight end trio. But for Jaden Maiava, any completion is a good one at this time in his career. Tripped up almost immediately was Courtney Reese. There was a gap, but he fell over in the second down upcoming.
Well, I'll give you the other guy at tight end, and I don't know what their plans are for Cooper Haswell. He's 6'3", about 210, so maybe they're going to use him in a redshirt year. But I think they believe he can be kind of a change-up weapon as a second tight end out there, smaller tight end, sort of, I'll have this position incorrect, but like an H-back, a tweener type guy. So they feel like that tight end room is pretty deep, and they really had to rebuild it. They had a lot of veteran tight ends the last 2 years who went bye-bye in terms of eligibility. So to quickly rebuild it for Nate Longshore,
and, you know, he was a big part of rebuilding it, they have an impressive room now.
Second down and five to go. Here's Maiava with some space around the outside. Jaden Maiava trucks the defender. He's across the line for a first down. Devontae Ford trying to stand in the way. Train's coming down the track for Jordan Maiava.
I bet you this quarterback's going to be afraid of me. Oh, no. Uh-oh. He just lowered his shoulder. He's bigger than me. Had good blocking on the edge. I think that was it was Thomas outside. Balloon guy, good blocking.
The late flag dropped onto the field
during
at the 36.
Run, holding number 19 on the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul, still second down.
All right, I saw that, but I just wanted to give Kaleo some credit, but the official saw a little tug of the jersey.
So that's why there was so much space around the outside. Dana Maiava with a minute 16 left to go, looking to put the finishing touches. It's been an outstanding day for UNLV.
And I think this is really big for Maiava. I think it's really big for UNLV fans to see the backup quarterback out there looking confident, running a myriad of different plays.
Here's Reese with it again. Ball's out. Was he down before? The ruling on the field is a live ball.
And after he was trucked, how about Devontae Ford coming up with, at least for now, a fumble recovery? We'll see if he was down after a potential review. Looks like they're going to let it go forward, able to hold on.
The ruling on the field was a fumble and recovered by the defense.
So in a day when UNLV has done such a good job of holding on to possession, a late fumble with a minute 7 to play.
Well, one positive on the play. Maiava hustled, made the tackle.
Bryant with the ball, likely going to be the last drive of the game for either team, as Dosakal gives to Schmidtke. Schmidtke wrestling up to midfield. His 44-point outburst on offense, holding this upstart Bryant offense to just 14 points. Which one of those are you more impressed with?
The outburst. I didn't know if the offense was going to be humming right out of the gates. That said, what a wishy-washy answer this is. Bryant really is a high-powered offense, and while they move the ball between the 20s and they've got, 407 yards total offense, when they needed to make stops, and I mean, that's a big part of college football on defense. Sometimes in some games, you bend, but you cannot break.
Second and 8, Schmidtke is down for gain of just 2 yards.
I'll mention one more thing about Maiava. I think it's good to have him out there from a comfort level, because you don't want this season being Doug Brumfield or bust, and last year, the season kind of turned on his injury in that San Jose State game,
and then Harrison Bailey just didn't look that prep. Cam Friel had a tough time. Friel's back, but to have a good backup quarterback, you got to have it in a long physical season.
And that'll do it. Time expiring as Barry Odom gets the Gatorade bath at midfield. You think this team is fired up for his first game as head coach or what?
Well, I think there's been some nerves these last couple of days here while you're all hitting each other in practice. You want to see what it's like when you turn on the lights and play against another team. And a couple of mistakes here and there, a couple of big gains, but most of that was nullified by big stops. So good defensive game from the Rebels, and I thought on offense the run game and the chunk plays were awesome.
Steve, your Raising Cane's player of the game, who is it?
I think the player of the game is Jacob DeJesus, 97-yard kickoff return, also 50 yards of offense. He really ignited him, and obviously the beginning of the game was pretty special, but DeJesus had a really good opening game for the Rebels.
Rebels put up 409 yards of total offense and outscored Bryant 44-14. UNLV moves to 10-4 against FCS opponents in the 21st century. Well, an opening game win with dominance in all three phases. The offense scoring, the defense stopping,
and the special teams making a huge impact. UNLV looking forward to a matchup next Saturday at the Big House as they travel to Ann Arbor to take on the Michigan Wolverines. They take care of business in week one, a 44-14 victory over FCS Bryant. Barry Odom gets a win in his first game as UNLV head coach. That'll do it for us here from Allegiant Stadium in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. My broadcast partner, Steve Cofield, for our director, Brian Williams, and everyone here with UNLV Athletics, I'm Matt Nevert saying thanks so much for tuning in.